it into your head, but hey, the Aeros are unbeaten in 96. Wednesday night, Houston played one of its best all-around games in its win over the Chicago Wolves. They hit, they hustle, and they made the plays to win the game. Tonight, they go for four in a row against Orlando next on Prime Sports. Live from the Summit in Houston, Texas, Prime Sports and the Houston Aeros present International Hockey League action. Tonight, the Houston Aeros take on the Orlando Solar Bears. Very pleasant good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Summit. The Aeros and the Solar Bears getting it on tonight. The Aeros have won three in a row. The Solar Bears are winless in their last three. And when you look at the standings in the Central Division of the Eastern Conference, Houston 6 points back of Atlanta, while Orlando is 4 points back in the top spot against the Cleveland Lumberjacks. And as I bring in my broadcast partner, Mike Greenlay, the Aeros, a great 2-1 win over the Chicago Wolves on Wednesday due to, in part, the play from Mike Yeo.
Well, certainly he probably had one of his best games of the season, and with two assists, he brings himself to another multi-point game, his sixth of the season. He only had one of those last year, and he has played very well. With his 10 goals and 12 assists, he's showing a pretty good campaign for the Aeros this year.
You know, whenever you talk about the play of Hubie McDonough, I mean, just what a terrific hockey player he is, and he's really raised the level of his play as of late.
Well, certainly in his last 11 games, he has 10 goals, 10 assists, and that brings him to 22 goals, 22 assists on the season. He's going to be very, very key to watch for an already strong offensive lineup for the Orlando Solar Bears.
And that takes us to our Oshman's game plan. It's brought to you by Oshman's Super Sports USA. And I think the Aeros need to get better results offensively.
Well, certainly, if you're going to allow less goals, you still have to get your goals, and they're going to have to score maybe three or four on Orlando to beat them. Secondly, they have to limit Orlando's opportunities. Orlando has a very strong offensive team, as we talked about. It's going to be important not to allow the Fishers and McDonoughs too many good, glorious opportunities. And third, overcome the psyche, and that is the psyche of not having beat Orlando Solar Bears this year. They see them five more times this season, so tonight would be a good place to start.
It's the Aeros and the Orlando Solar Bears, and when we return, we throw it to the Prime Sports Clubhouse. This is Houston Aeros Hockey on Prime Sports.
Secondly, you have to limit Orlando's opportunities. We talked about their offensive prowess.
You're going to get thirsty. That's why you need Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Life's a sport. Drink it up. Welcome back to the Summit, everybody. Adam Gordon along with Mike Greenlay. It's the fifth meeting this season between the Aeros and the Orlando Solar Bears. And let's take a look at the starting lineup brought to you by Southwest Airlines. For the Orlando Solar Bears up front, Alfie Turcotte with John LeBlanc and Hubie McDonough. Defensively, Jeff Cirka and Brad Tiley. And in goal, it is Alan Bester, who is making his second appearance against the Aeros this year. He won earlier in the first meeting. He's 16-8-2 with a 3.56 goals against average. The lineup for the Houston Aeros is as follows. Arneil, Kelly Hurd, Mark Freer with Gord Krupke and Mike Hurlbutt. And in goal, Grant Shervin. And Shervin has gone the distance here. This is his sixth consecutive start. His goals against has dipped below two at 1.81 and a 93.5 save percentage. Aeros defend the goal to our right. The Solar Bears the goal to our left. And we're underway. The first of three games in three nights for the Houston Aeros. It is Mike Hurlbutt behind the net. He'll set it up for check by Turcotte. Cleared the puck to center, and it goes back into the Orlando zone. Tiley chased back behind the cage as the Aeros set up in their forechecking system. Puck goes to the far side. It's cleared out at center, looking for McDonough. Out of the net, Grant Shervin. He'll throw it along the boards. Jammed near side, Arneil trying to get it out of there. In there is Freer as they dig some more. Puck in the corner for Krupke. Fired at far side for Kelly Hurd to the line, not out. It was held by Cirka at a left point. Behind McDonough. Looks in front, centered for Turcotte. And then it was knocked away, and then a shot went on to Grant Shervin from John LeBlanc, and a stick save there. 45 seconds gone in the first. Scoreless hockey game. Aeros shoot the puck the length of the ice, and it's no icing as Cirka fell. He's shaken up, down. I think he caught a rut and is a little slow to get up.
Well, his legs went straight into the boards as he fell down and went sliding into the boards, but he did finally get up. probably hurt his knee as he came flying in to get the puck, and he looked like he just lost an edge.
Oh,
and that, ooh, he hit the boards pretty good. His foot caught a rut there and just went down. This ice is a little choppy. I mean, when you have the Rockets playing on opposite nights like you do, they have to lay down that floor on top of the ice, and it usually makes it pretty rough.
His skates look like your shock absorbers on your car.
Well,
watch it.
That's fine, but that ankle only has so much tension in it, and it just can only take so much as it goes into the boards feet first. Always dangerous about that low part of the board, because that's where the boards are anchored, right along the bottom there, and it's solid down there.
Peter Horacek, the assistant coach, helping out Kurt Frazier tonight. And a faceoff to the right side of Alan Bester. Lamb to take the draw against Neil Eisenhut. Arrows win the draw back to a left point. Jakes, who sat out the last contest against Chicago in this new defensive rotation scheme that Dave Tippett has implemented for now. It is Slivchenko right side. Center ice pass misses Jakes, and Turgeon regroups at center. Sylvain Turgeon back into his own end for Laniel. Turned it near side. The Solo Bears have come out here in the first minute and are very aggressively attacking the Arrow puck carriers. It is Mike Hartman in his own zone. Sends the pass over to Mark Ferner. Center ice, the Solo Bears shoot it in. Back to play. It was going to be Scherzer, but to try as Hartman comes in there, and we've got a whistle, and we've got our first penalty of the night. Scott Hansen is our referee, and he's got a holding minor.
Well, it's going to be on Turgeon, as Turgeon spun around the Orlando player as he was coming into the zone, and that's interference. But you never know. And Mike Hartman might know. I thought Mike Hartman might get one too for charging afterwards, but it's going to be Turgeon alone. And with that minor, the Orlando Solar Bears will go on the power play really early in this game. And the Arrows aren't going to have I'm not going to say they had an easy time with anybody, but they're going to have a more difficult time with Orlando than they did with a few of the other teams that they've played recently.
Head coach Dave Tippett talking before the game, he was saying that he was concerned a little bit about the fact that his team was outchanced against Chicago, but he was really happy, as you can see the penalty, Turgeon spinning around Duncanson. But he was concerned about the way he was outchanced. But Tippett was saying, though, what was really the bright spot was the penalty killing.
Well, certainly, and hopefully that penalty killing will be just as strong right now. The Arrows can't allow too many good chances by the guys like this. Right now, you have their power play unit out on the ice, and it's going to be a test for their penalty killers right now.
Off the draw, the Arrows spank it along the boards. It'll go all the way down the ice. Alan Bester couldn't find the handle, and Brad Tiley goes back to play it. 18:20 to go in the first, still a scoreless hockey game. But Orlando on the power play as the puck goes in. Dave Barr, he's out there with Fisher and Beaufait. This has been the line for Orlando for the entire season. Back to the line, Barr. He'll work it down the right side for Fisher in the corner, knocked away. Here's Conroy turning in his own end. Lead pass, Yo, romping center ice. Shorthanded, Yo across the line. Yo, great move, right in on goal. He lost an edge and fell. Cut right in, and then down he went. And the puck is picked up by Beaufait. Beaufait takes a bump from Conroy. After it, Beaufait. Conroy sizes him up, trying to take the puck away. Can't. Barr flipped it ahead for Fisher across the line. Poke checked away. And back to play it. It's Todd Richards at the point. Richards, left side Barr. Looped it down. Beaufait shoots. It was blocked by none other than Gord Donnelly. Here's the puck behind the net. Beaufait looped it back. Barr. Dave Barr with 53 on the power play. Got it down. Beaufait shoots. Stick save by Shervin. It's chipped away by Donnelly. He slammed the puck ahead to Yo, and it was cleared. You're allowed to hand pass if you've got the puck in your own end. Here come the Solar Bears. Pat Neaton across the line. Neaton, one of two American board defensemen for Orlando, and then he was just hammered off the puck. And the Solar Bears regroup at center. Ferner with 3 minutes gone in the first, still no score, but 27 on the power play for Orlando. Puck at center, Neaton takes a bump from Arneil, and here comes Freer shorthanded. Freer in the goal, big save by Bester, he will hold on. 16:49 to go in the first, no score, 18 seconds remaining in the penalty to Sylvain Turgeon.
You know, normally you don't want to see a power play for the opposing team this early, but right now it's kind of got the Arrows going a little bit. Having to kill that penalty off and do some good defensive hitting and right along the boards. You see Donnelly just laying out, I think it was Neaton, I'm not sure, it might have been, yeah, it was Neaton as he got thrown down to the ice pretty good. And Donnelly blocking shots and getting into this game with a couple big hits. It's good to see a lot of the guys doing that right now.
Face off to the left side of Alan Bester. Mark Freer against Hubie McDonough. And Arneil is out there with Freer. The Arrows come in as as we talked a little bit about their power play troubles, they are worse than the IHL as far as giving up shorthanded goals. They've given up 15 and yet haven't really posted many themselves this year. Puck is turned in around the zone as we're down to 5 seconds on the power play. Here's the puck, right wing boards. Turner down the right side, shooting his block by Mike Hurlbutt, shot down the ice. Mike Hurlbutt getting Gabe Tippett's accolades after the last hockey game. Thought he played terrific.
Especially coming off something like that, he didn't show any hesitation at all towards hitting or moving the puck.
Here come the Solar Bears. McDonough shooting upstairs and missed the net. Puck to the near side, McDonough again. Trying to loop it down in the corner. Turcotte worked on there by Jakes. Here's Pat Neaton, sends it down, missed the pass for LeBlanc. LeBlanc behind that, give to McDonough. McDonough turning out in front. It was knocked away. And here come the Houston Arrows. Lamb a pass off the stick of Turgeon. Ferner trying to clear it, and it's out to neutral ice. Still no score in the hockey game. Solar Bears, Turcotte across the line, trying to move one down. Here's the shot, score! It got behind Shervin, as is it with Hubie McDonough, and the Solar Bears take a 1-0 lead.
So Hubie McDonough gets his 23rd on the year on a kind of a play that was, I guess, the puck was trickling in front, and he just took a swat at it, and it seemed to have eyes as it found the five hole. They come across the line and just move it forward. McDonough throws on the Jets. Lanielle can't handle it, and they're just chopping away at it. McDonough gets a backhand on it and just chops it between the legs of Shervin. Shervin didn't know whether to reach for it or whether to wait for it. He elected to go down, and it got underneath him before he could get down to his knees, and the Orlando Solar Bears lead it 1-0.
McDonough was scoreless in Indianapolis on the 17th in the 5-4 shootout loss, but as you said, coming in 11 in 11 games, has 20 points on 10 goals and 10 assists, make that now 11 goals. And the Solar Bears lead it by a score of 1-0. 4.5 gone in the first. Puck shot into the arrow end. It's Duncanson right side, had it chipped away by Turgeon. And here is Mark Lamb. Lamb to Sylvain Turgeon, center ice. Turgeon right side, brings it across the line. It goes into Alan Bester, and he'll steer it in behind the net. Picked up by Cirka. Fired it along the board. It hit the skates of Hartman. Solar Bears jump on it and clear it all the way the length of the ice. O'Connor to play it, and they're going to say that O'Connor could have played it. Thus, no icing. O'Connor in his own end. Quickly cleared a pass to center for Maurice. He turned it neutral. It's jammed ahead. Maurice trying to get it across the line. That'll go offside. Maurice coming in. Give it to Yo. White shoots, and he hammered a slap shot wide of the net. Here's Conroy again, right side. Looped it down for Maurice. Centered. Yo had it stuck aside, and it's picked up by O'Connor. Right side, Maurice. Bumped by Hartman, and it's cleared to Craig Duncanson. He'll move to center ice. Duncanson hoists it into the arrow end. Grant Shervin out of the net to play. Here's Miles O'Connor with 14.5 to go in the first in a 1-0 Solar Bear lead.
The arrow showing no hesitation getting back into this one.
It is Mark Beaufait turning it center ice as it's controlled by Ferner. Headman pass to Frederick, and he shoots it into the arrow end. Right side, Beaufait knocked away by O'Connor, and he will shoot that up over the glass and out of play. Let's take a timeout. 1-0 Orlando. We'll be right back, but first, this word from Southwest Airlines. It's a 1-0 Solar Bear lead on Hubie McDonough's goal, 14-16 to play. In the first period, you think the fans like it greener? They're rooting for Al Conroy to get a goal.
They certainly are. Certainly one of the fan favorites here.
Oh, he has become a fan favorite. I'd almost say maybe his first home game when he got back after the trade, he was popular like that.
I'd like to see him get a point tonight. It would be his 100th in the IHL.
And it didn't take him long, did it?
No, it didn't.
Here's the puck controlled by Donnelly in his own end. Donnelly, a pass to the near side for Miles O'Connor, and he'll move it out to center ice. Left wing, drilled off the puck, but Yo is there. Yo was worked on by the Solar Bear defenseman. Finally picked up again. Yo, near side, takes a bump from Todd Richards. Skate to skate in the corner. Maurice gathers in the puck for Houston. Yo in there battling as well. Maurice centered one. It came to the line. O'Connor the drive. Deflected just wide. Yo rebound. Oh, and I think Bester got a piece of that one. It came to the near side. Conroy. Conroy chipped it down in the corner for Ferner. Rolled it behind for Richards. He will turn and scoop it ahead. It's 1-0 Orlando. Oh, puck was turned out in front. Here's a chance. Houston's got it. Donnelly wrist shot. Deflected away. I think Yo got a stick on it. So Mike Yo, Mr. Greenlay, is taking over right where he left off against Chicago.
I think he just stepped right out of the last game and right into this game because he is all over the ice already with chances. Right off the bat, he made a great move earlier on in the game, and now he's getting in front and deflecting some of those shots.
All right, well, guess what's coming up, folks? It is the Super Bowl. You can bring a minimum of 2 cans of soup on January 24th and receive 2 $10 tickets for the price of one. It, of course, goes to a very good cause, bringing your food. So just bring your cans. You have to bring 2 of them. And the January 24th game is the game we hope to see it. It's the Super Bowl right here at the Summit.
So the Arrows finding themselves down a little bit right off the bat, 1-0, but they've shown a lot of good pressure in the last few minutes. So I think it was maybe a little bit of a wake-up call for the Arrows, and now they're trying to forge forward and get something going.
Here is Steve Jenks off the faceoff. His wrist shot missed the net. And that was another thing that Dave Tippett had talked about, how he wants to see his defenseman hit the net more. They shot the puck a lot last game, but didn't hit the net. Puck came in front. Townsend couldn't get it. O'Neill with a drive, and that blistered just wide of the net. Puck to the far corner, picked up by Pat Neaton, base of the right circle. Neaton scoops one ahead, and here comes Barr to center ice, but back to play at O'Neill. Dave Barr was the IHL's most valuable player in the All-Star game here in Houston. Had a goal and an assist in the contest. Puck is at center, fighting for the loose puck. Here's Bob Joyce cutting in. Joyce, the backhanders! Did that go in?
That went in the net.
That went in the net. Here's another shot. Sherman Stave rebound. Stop that. I'm telling you what, that puck went in the net. As sure as I'm standing here, I think that puck went in the net.
Well, it either did that or hit the crossbar without making a sound, but I think that went right up inside the corner, and with the net so taut as it is, a lot of times it'll hit inside there and came right out. The goal judge didn't, Orlando didn't even make any kind of, we're going to have to take a really close look at this one. It came up really high, and right up, it did hit the inside of the post. Wow, that did hit the inside of the post, and we didn't hear anything. Sometimes it does hit the post and doesn't make a sound, but that had beat Shervin on the far side and came right back in front of him. Or actually came out back in behind.
I don't know, but I would like to take one more peek at that one. I still think it might have caught Twine, and if it catches Twine, it's in the net.
Well, you notice that not one Orlando player made any objections, so obviously they thought it hit the post as well.
Puck is bounding in the arrow end. Loose gathered. Here's the shot. Shervin, the save. Rebound, and he will cover up as Turgeon fired it into him, and we'll take timeout. 12.5 to go in the first. It's the Solar Bears 1. Arrows no score. Back after this.
Is a superstar spokesman what makes Oshman's Super Sports USA?
Dream on.
Oshman's is supersized and super fun. Why, you can play your favorite sport right in the store. Shoot hoops, hit golf balls, swing a bat, or a racket. Or get your kick to 100 other fun ways. Think there's a more super sports store than Oshman's Super Sports?
In your dreams.
The dream starts at Oshman's with 13 Houston area locations.
Texaco has joined the Aero Force. It's time for you to experience Houston Aeros Pro Hockey, and Texaco has your ticket. Stop by participating Houston area Texaco locations. Fill up with 8 gallons of Clean System 3 gasoline and get a special coupon for a free hockey ticket when you buy one. Available only at Texaco. Experience sticks swinging, pucks flying, bodies crashing with Houston Aeros Hockey today. Houston Aeros Pro Hockey and Texaco. Take it to the star.
1-0 Solar Bears, and let's go to the audio portion of our program as Bob Joyce, did he hit the post or did it go in?
Sounds like post to me.
Yeah.
All right, I'm wrong.
It did look like it went in the far corner, but you know those the way they make those nets these days, they're so tight that if you do hit inside of them sometimes, they come right back out very quickly. But you did hear it. We didn't hear it up here, but after he turned it up a little bit, you could hear the post.
And that explains why they didn't complain. They can hear it down there. We couldn't hear it up here. Here comes Mike Maurice, right side. Cuts in front, turns, couldn't get a shot away, and it's cleared out at neutral ice. Back into the arrow, and it goes. Shervin will let O'Connor play as Turcotte goes into forecheck. Here's a quick pass out to the far side for Mike Maurice. He'll send it the length, or the width rather, for Yo. Give it to Conroy. Conroy makes his move, shoots, and he's hit the line. I'll tell you, Al Conroy starting to add some moves to his repertoire. We saw that spinorama in the Chicago game, and there he made a pretty nice move. The puck is at center. Kiley shot it into arrow territory. It came into the near corner. Fighting for it. Turcotte, the block, the shot short side, and it was made by Shervin. And now Conroy and Hubie McDonough looking at each other a little bit. Hubie McDonough, who's got the only goal in this hockey game, and he's kind of glaring a little bit. And Grant Shervin looking on, making a nice glove save. With this three-game streak that the Arrows are on, how about these numbers? 6 of their last 9 have been decided by one goal. 3 victories in the current streak have been by one goal. The win, by the way, over Chicago was their first win in the under Dave Tippett in regulation. And then look at the goals against. 4.22 per game on the year, but 10 goals in the last five. And the guy you're seeing right there, for those of you watching on Prime, Dave Tippett has done a terrific job in getting the Arrows on track here.
It certainly has. He has the guys playing to their capabilities, and actually he expects more out of these guys, so maybe you should expect more too, because you might see it.
Here is Pat Neaton, right side. He'll turn it into the corner for Hurlbutt, jammed it back to the line, and Kelly Hurd cleared it out at center. Back to play at Mike Hartman in his own end. He's defensively paired with Patrick Neaton. He's jammed to the near side. Ooh, nearly turned over. Can Lamb get there? He's after it into the far corner. He and Barr go at it. Here's the puck jammed out to center ice for Mike Hartman and into the Arrow end. Shervin slows it behind the net with 11:23 to go in the first. 1-0 Orlando. Puck is along the far boards. Kelly Hurd, give it to Mark Lamb. Streaking at center with Turgeon. Give it to Turgeon. Trying to cut in, but again, Sylvain losing it off his stick. And Pat Neaton will clear it all the way down the ice. It will not be icing. Hurlbutt goes back to play it. Shervin will escort it behind the net. Hurlbutt chasing after it. Jammed it along the boards for Sylvain Turgeon. Out at center ice, but Neaton back to play. Here's the puck into the Arrow end. Arneil fighting for a loose puck. Lanyel moves it out at center. And here comes Graham Townsend. Rumbling right side across the line. Townsend pushed it into the corner. Hartman goes in there to play it, and he'll fire to the far side for Mark Ferner. Beaufay turning it center. Beaufay, long pass for Frederick. Frederick dropped it back. Here's the shot by Beaufay, deflected away by Lanyel. Worked to the near side. It was held in by Craig Fisher. They battle for it near side. Lanyel turning, and the Arrows are off the center ice. It's 3-on-3. Arneil left side with Freer and Townsend. Here's Freer right in, but it went from the skates and into the corner. Now Circa going in there, but it's picked up by Freer. Center and Arneil. They score!
Back together again.
Freer and Arneil are back.
Ed Freer does a lot of work behind the net. He carries it out and dumps it right from outside the far post and right out in front. And Arneil may waste no time in letting it go. It goes five hole on the defenseman, and then it beats Bester over the pad, blocker side. A great job by Freer fighting it off behind the net, and Arneil gets a good hard shot on goal.
The Dallas Cowboys may have Aikman to Irvin, but the Arrows have Freer to Arneil, and it's a 1-1 hockey game with 10:18 to go in the first. It is Steve Jenks. The pass for Freer again. Shoots right on Bester. Stick save. Loose in front. Great save by Bester. Stood up with a stick save again. Puck in the corner. Fisher trying to clear the zone. Can't do it. Townsend. Townsend right side. Trying to move in. It's knocked away. Boy, the Arrows all of a sudden with a jump again. It's a tie hockey game at one. Lanyel back in his own end with under 10 minutes remaining in the first. It's out at center ice. Brad Tiley trying to move it ahead, jumped on by Arneil. Arneil had it stripped by Fisher and shot down the ice. It will be icing as O'Connor goes back and whistle stops play. It's a 1-1 hockey game with 9:40 remaining, and out comes the line with Dave Barr and Neil Eisenhut and Bob Joyce. And an interesting story about Dave Barr. You talk about guys that have been around for a while. How about Dave Barr, who has been in hockey, professional hockey, now entering his 15th professional season? And you know, he is of the top 42 picks in 1980 when he was drafted. He is only one of 12 that are still playing. And we mentioned the IHL MVP in the All-Star game. He's a terrific hockey player, and I don't care if he's 15 years in the league or 5 years.
He's certainly stood the test of time, because hockey can be a sport that can really wear someone down, and he's been around for a while.
Puck is in the Orlando zone. It's picked up by Neil Eisenhut, and he'll skate to center ice. Eisenhut for Barr, intercepted by Turgeon. He let a lead pass go for Kelly Hurd. It was jammed right back out at center. 9:27 to go in the first, a 1-1 game. Back is Ferner in his own end. He was scraped off the puck by Turgeon, and it's ripped back into the Orlando zone. To play it, Todd Richards. He was here in the IHL All-Star game for the Eastern Conference. It is Todd Richards, the former Las Vegas Thunder defenseman, shoots the puck in. Eisenhut knocked it down. It is picked up by the Arrows. Mike Hurlbutt give it to Turgeon. Turgeon near side. He was bumped by Dave Barr. Barr fighting for the loose puck. Eisenhut overskates it. And here is Lamb. He'll turn it out at center ice. After it, it's Gord Krupke. Give it to Turgeon, and he'll fire it into the Orlando zone. Back at neutral ice, it's Dave Barr once again. Rink-wide pass, jammed away by Lamb, and the Arrows are back to play it. Krupke, right side for Houston. He'll shoot the puck into the Orlando zone. It's picked up by Ferner. He'll turn it around. Ferner, the cross-ice pass for Joyce. Team captain for the Solar Bears. Sherman right on. Stick save made by Sherman. And it's jammed away by the Arrows. Here's Maurice. Scoots it to the line. Not out. Circa held into the drive. That one upstairs on Krupke. Bounced in the corner for O'Connor. And he'll spank that to center ice. It got through Neaton. Yo going after it. Neaton trying to shade him off the puck. That's almost interference, if you will, or obstruction. But play goes on. Here's O'Connor, picks up a loose puck at center ice, trying to jam it away. Ooh, he almost fired that to McDonough. Here's the far side for Gord Donnelly, and it goes into the Orlando zone. Both teams very aggressive here, Greener, as far as their forechecking, and they're making the other team hurry their passes, which means we might see our number of mistakes tonight.
There might be some giveaways, you're right, and right now the Arrows, that's part of their system, and they're trying to implement it.
And I'm telling you, ooh, here's a puck that took a weird pop. In front, and Sherman says, oh no, he better get back there, and he was able to escort that away. We've seen that a number of times this year where it just takes a hop off that corner. Now the puck is out at center ice. Turcotte jammed it into the arrow end. Back to play at Gord Donnelly. He'll work it the length of the ice. Icing is indicated, but Richards is back to play, and there'll be no icing. 7:20 remaining in the first period. Still a 1-1 hockey game. It goes down into the arrow end to play it. Lanielle in behind the net. He was forechecked by Hartman. Arneil fighting for it with Neil Eisenhut in the corner. They continue to go skate to skate in there. Now it came out in front. Jakes is there, and we are going to have a penalty. We'll sort it out when we return. 7:05 to go in the first period. It's the Arrows 1. It's the Solar Bears 1. And we're back after this.
Welcome back to the Summit. Jeff Cirka has two goals on the year. He almost finds his third in the most peculiar way. He dumps it in, and it hits one of the middle bars on the glass, and it comes back. Of course, Shervin's going back to stop it, and it cuts across the crease. You know, we talked about the basketball being in here so often. They have to take those boards up and down and up and down, and there's sometimes some, deficiencies in there when they put them back in.
Puck is back in the Orlando zone with 7 minutes remaining in the first. It's a 1-1 game, a penalty to Scott Arneil. So the Solar Bears on their second power play of the evening. It is controlled by Brad Tiley in his own zone. He'll send it out center ice, and now Dave Barr across the line. Barr cutting in, gets it over to Richards, sends it down, the pass miss Fisher. Loose puck tapped away as O'Connor roughing Fisher up pretty good along the boards now. Kicked in there, it came out to Barr. Barr, the pass to the line, Tiley getting set. Here's Tiley, centered! It went and hit skates and deflected away. Now the puck is jammed to the near side and out at center ice. It is Fisher trying to move it ahead, and it's taken back by Tiley. Cross ice pass for Barr. Dumps it into the corner. O'Connor after it. Barr in there as well, and finally jammed away. It came back to the line. Tiley winds, fakes the shot, sends it down. Here's a chance for Buffet. Buffet scrambling in the corner. Buffet turning, sends it back to the line. Here's Todd Richards. Cross ice, Tiley with 49 on the power play. Richards scooped it down. One time shot, Sherman the save. And here's Al Conroy. He'll turn it his own end and just drift up ice and gently roll it back into the Orlando zone. Maurice after it. Richards in the corner. Maurice takes him into the boards with a hit. Puck came to the near side. Pat Neaton in the corner. Watched by Freer. Freer trying to dig the puck out. It came over to Neaton behind the net. Neaton turning with 5:30 to go in the first in a 1-1 hockey game. Here comes Neaton out at neutral ice. Neaton across the line. He'll dump the puck into the arrow zone. Back to play at Perlbutt. Perlbutt jammed it ahead to the line. Not out. Power play down to 10 seconds. Here's the puck rolled along the boards. Neaton trying to lead. Maurice pushing him along the wall. I'll tell you what, Mike Maurice, as they're going to call it, a hand pass on Orlando, but Mike Maurice is a guy that last night had the one assist, but really, I see a new Mike Maurice. I see an aggressive Mike Maurice, and that is very good news for the Houston Arrows.
Well, certainly. He's really laying the body a lot, and he seems to be forechecking with, like you said, a lot more vigor. He is really going after that puck, and that's one of the things that's going to lend to the success of the Houston Arrows is puck pursuit.
Don't miss family entertainment at its best at the Summit. See the wonderful world of horses featuring the famous Royal Lipizzan Stallions. It's tomorrow at 2 and 7:30 right here at the Summit. Off the faceoff, the Arrows have got it. Inside hurl, but jammed it ahead. It goes into the Orlando zone. Pat Neaton turning, watched by Lamb, and Lamb crushed him into the boards. Big hit there. Now Lamb fighting for it with Neaton. It's jammed back to the line. Krupke couldn't hold it in. And it'll go the length of the ice. After it, Hurlbutt. He's sized up by... drilled into the boards, and this is going to be a penalty on Joe Frederick. And Mike Hurlbutt a little slow to get up here. We'll sort it out when we return. It's a 1-1 hockey game, and we'll have it when we return.
Back at the Summit, Frederick's going to get a penalty, and what a thing to happen to someone like Mike Hurlbutt after coming off an injury of getting hit into the boards. Frederick takes him from behind, and he lays him right into the boards, and he takes a good hard hit in there, and I suppose it's one or the other. It's a good test to see if he's really back, but what a terrible thing to happen to a guy that just came off an injury of that nature.
It's been a rough year for Mike Hurlbutt. But he bounced up. He seems to be okay, but at this point, you know, I haven't really gotten a chance to get to know the guy yet, but you wonder if it starts getting into the back of the mind now when you start going after loose pucks, if you have to turn your head. Here's Turgeon, right side, shoots the puck in. Arrows on their first power play of the night. Here is O'Connor, right side for Lamb, scooped it down for Turgeon. Turgeon setting up on the power play. It is Turgeon, right circle, moving in, winding, shooting, Bester saving, rebound just scoots wide. Here is Yo, Mike Yo, base of the right circle, get it for Turgeon. Turgeon getting set, wide, shoots, deflected, ooh, getting in front of that was Ferner. He'll be feeling that for a week, and here's another penalty coming up by Fink to Orlando. A hooking call, and the Arrows are gonna get a two-man advantage.
Serka got a little too happy with his stick there as Yo was pursuing a puck. He hauls him down, and even before he had a chance to dump it down the ice, the whistle goes, and so the faceoff will also come down deep into the Orlando zone. Mike Yo went after the puck, and as he was spinning around to play it, he was hauled down. And a good call by referee Scott Hansen. The Arrows have a 5-on-3. This will give him a chance to jump ahead in this game.
So Serka in the box, 2 for hooking. And the Arrows will have 1:29 of a two-man advantage and a chance to take the lead for the first time. And there's Kurt Frazier talking with Peter Horacek, his assistant. Horacek looks like he's doing most of the talking, though, but they're trying to sort out how they're going to handle things here. It's Freer now with Yeo and Turgeon, Conroy and Lamb. So Dave Tippett going with 5 forwards on this power play. This is a common thing you will see on a 5-on-3. A lot of times a coach will go with 5 forwards if they can contain the puck. Todd Richards rips the puck to the near side. Conroy held it in nicely. Conroy left side. He'll move it down for Freer. Back to Conroy. Left side moving down the circle. Conroy waits to Lamb. Top of the slot. Lamb waiting. Here's the shot by Turgeon. Score! A one-time drive. Wow, what a goal. It's a 2-1 hockey game.
Turgeon lets that one rip from the top of the circle. It was a great pass by Lamb. And, you know, you see these guys practicing that in practice, beating each other the one-time shots, because some players like to take the puck off the front of the skate, the back of the skate, and some like to take it right in the middle. But he gets a pass from Conroy. Conroy gives it to Lamb. Lamb slides it across. And Turgeon in one motion, right off inside the post, up under the bar. And, you know what, I don't think there are too many goalies that would get a piece of that, as Turgeon just lets this one fly, and it's in and out of the net even before Bester can react. Great goal by Turgeon, his 15th of the season.
What a goal. It is Mike Hurlbutt out there with O'Connor, and the puck goes into the Orlando zone. Back to play it, Kiley. He'll hammer it along the wall. It came to the line, Hurlbutt held it. Arrows are still on the power play, remember. That came before the two-man advantage expired. Richards wrestling Freer off the puck. It came to Arneal, base of the right circle. Back to the line, Hurlbutt. Wide, shoots it, right on Bester the save. Ooh, Freer was wreaking havoc in front. Watch for Hurlbutt to shoot the puck more after everybody kind of looking at that last game, the way he was ripping the puck. Don't forget, this guy was an AHL All-Star last year with Cornwall. It is Freer in the corner. Freer sends it right in front. Townsend trying to bang one wide, though. It came to Joyce. It got it to the line, and it's a Hubie McDonough turnaround. McDonough across the line, shorthanded. Cuts in, and he's wrestled off by Miles O'Connor, and Townsend is there to play it. Graham Townsend turning with 48 seconds remaining on the power play. Over to Mike Hurlbutt. He'll jam it out at center, but the Solar Bears are back at their own blue line. Pat Neaton, forechecked by Arneal, and he'll just shoot that all the way down. Oh, it takes a hop and goes out of play, and that'll bring the faceoff back into the Orlando zone with 2:49 remaining in the first. 2-1 Houston, 35 seconds remaining in the Jeff Serka Minor.
So the Arrows making quick work on that power play. As you see, Jakes coming back into the game. He missed last game, of course, in that rotation that they're doing. But Jakes is a good guy to be back in against the Solar Bears. He's +3, and he's +7 on the season.
plus three against this one team. So that's pretty good for him. He's collected assists in his last three outings, and he's just 3 points shy of 100-point mark in his IHL career.
Face off left side of Alan Bester. Picked up by Maurice. Power play down to 30 seconds. Here's Lanyell. Wrist shot blocked in front by Ferner, and he'll scamper to center ice. Mark Ferner, give it to Dave Barr. It's shot into the arrow end. Jakes goes back to play. Steve Jakes, who has an assist in each of his last two games, of course did not play against Chicago, and the puck is controlled by Lanyell. Pass goes into the Orlando zone. Ferner back to point. Aim to the near side. Conroy jammed it down for Maurice. Maurice turning. Maurice in the corner. Takes a bump from Ferner. And Ferner will take over as the power play is over. And teams are at five aside. Circa whips it into the arrow zone. It comes squarely out in front. But Lanyell back to play it. Lanyell heading in behind the net. He'll come out in a pass over to Kelly Hurd. Hurd tips it for Jakes as the arrow start up ice. Jakes give it to Hurd across the line. Hurd had it poke check though. And it's right back out at center for Lanyell. Back to his own blue line. Lanyell scooped it off the boards, and it's back into the Orlando end. Tiley shot it into arrow territory. 1:40 to go in the first period. Houston 2, Orlando 1. Might as well just keep the scoring tablature the same for Sunday when the Houston Rockets take on the Orlando Magic. As the puck is offsides, and rumor has it that Kurt Frazier, the head coach of the Solar Bears, might use Shaquille O'Neal tonight if he needs a man in front.
That would be some man in front.
Could you imagine him trying to get a puck by Shaquille O'Neal or trying to move Shaquille out of the slot?
Yeah, he's got a big five hole. The guys would really take care of that. There's another veteran. You talk about veterans. There's John LeBlanc. Last year, he played in Springfield. This year with the Orlando Solar Bears, getting some time up front.
It's a face-off at center ice. Conroy against McDonough with 1:28 to go in the first. It is Donnelly over to Yo. It's turned around and Turcotte give it to Richards. Shoots one in there and Shervin makes the glove save and he'll hold on. So Grant Shervin, after giving up a soft goal, but it looked like he was a little surprised by the McDonough goal, played some terrific hockey again here in this first period. The Orlando Solar Bears, as of late, have had their problems. They're 26-11-4, which is terrific, but they have not won since the All-Star break. And there you can also see they lost to Atlanta Tuesday, and they lost in a shootout to Indianapolis Wednesday 5-4.
Well, I think that has a lot to do with teams picking up their play a little bit, everybody racing towards the playoffs. Kurt Frazier, coach of the Orlando Solar Bears, just want to get his team back on that kind of streak that he had before Christmas.
Face-off controlled by Houston. Here's Maurice, right side, shoots it into the Orlando zone. And to the near side, Conroy. Conroy flipped it into the corner. Maurice fighting for it. They go at it in behind the net. And Mark Buffet back to play. Maurice wrestling pretty good in there. Maurice trying to dig it out. Maurice had it, sends it out in front. Here's Yo cutting down the left side. Mike Yo in behind the net. Yo looks in front. Yo, good work along the board. Sends it behind the net for Maurice. He takes a bump from Tiley. It's centered. Oh, and it was tripped over the net by Yo. A marvelous chance there. Yo trying to get away from Buffet. Yo in behind the net. Wraparound block. Conroy in front. Oh, dude, that just wide after Bester took a chance. And the puck is cleared out at center. The puck is Fisher. He's drilled along the boards by Donnelly. Now Yo behind the net. Works it along the far wall. He'll give it to Graham Townsend. Barreling at center ice. Townsend rips the shot. Oh, that went just wide of the net. Arneil gathers it in. Here's Arneil just missing fair with a pass. It came to the far side. Boy, the Arrows really moving the puck. Kripke the drive. Oh, great save. Rebound. Oh, went behind Bester and teetered on the goal line. Wow, Bester will hold on.
Putting a lot of pressure on the Houston Arrows. Freer almost gets a goal to add to his assist tonight. He chops away at it, gets a couple opportunities, but the puck just didn't want to go in the net. A good shot from the side, and Freer jams away at it, gets a couple shots. This one goes up over the shoulder of Bester, and it just lands right on the goal line. And Bester able to see it. It wasn't a very fast shot as it rose up over his shoulder, but it dropped down and it could have been knocked in by himself, but he does get the glove on it before it crosses that goal line. So we've seen about two or three really close chances, with that one that hit the post down in the arrow end, the one that went off the glass, and now this one that teetered on the goal line.
4 seconds to go in the first. Top of the puck, and that should be the period. Barr will clear it, not out. Hurlbut held it in, was going to drill the shot, but the buzzer sounds, ending. And now, hold on, we've got, oh no, okay, Hurlbut was looking. He wants to talk to the referee. But our score, after 20 minutes of action from the Summit, it's the Houston Aeros 2, the Orlando Solar Bears 1. We'll have more for the Summit right after this. Back in the Summit, everybody. Adam Gordon along with Mike Greenlay. It's a 2-1 hockey game, and what an outstanding hockey. You know what, Greener, I was thinking back to the Chicago game, which was a terrific hockey game, just, you know, for the fans to watch. And here's another one that's off to a great start. I don't think I can take the remainder of the season all like this, but I'll tell you what, I will take it.
We'll have to give you a pacemaker or something. That period was very fast. I looked up at the clock, and all of a sudden the period was over. Good fast-paced action, a lot of good hard hitting, and that's kind of hockey that seems to be what the Aeros want right now, because they play best in it.
You know, and it looked like it was two systems that were working really well as far as the forechecking. The Aeros went in with their system and were attacking a puck carry, but on the same side, I thought Orlando's forechecking was terrific as well.
Both very effective, but then again, both teams playing well defensively, taking care of their own end, and so when they did get the play broken up deep in their zone, they had people there to help out and finally get the puck out. So I think what you're seeing is basically a battle of two systems in the forecheck, but also a battle of some defensive capabilities as well.
We didn't get a chance to talk about it too much after it happened, but I think this brings up a point about Mike Hurlbut, about, again, he was a little slow to get up, and I don't know if he was just being careful, but earlier in the period, he took a check from behind from Joe Frederick. It was a penalty. But if you're Mike Hurlbut now, you have the injury, which has got to scare the living daylights out of you regardless, and then this happens again. What do you think goes through his mind?
Well, you know, I think what goes through his mind is, first of all, it's the, I guess, the obvious saying, wow, that was close. But yeah. Then again, he looks at it and he says, hey, maybe that's a good little test to see where I'm at. You don't want that kind of test, but it's a good test to see where he is. He hit the boards pretty hard. He got hit from behind. And, you know, players don't like to get hit from behind, and that's why penalties are called in that situation. But it's a good little test for him. And now he says, maybe he is saying to himself, well, I've been hit from behind now, so now I don't have to worry about it because I know I'm back.
Exactly. Although it would be kind of fun to watch him, because I noticed it a couple of times tonight where he just kind of turned his head a little bit behind him just to take a look, which is common. A lot of guys do that when they're going in there. But, you know, it'll be kind of neat to find out what's going on. But We've got Scott Arneal standing by, and Scotty, hockey team leading 2-1, and I'd like to get your thoughts on that first period.
Well, certainly fast pace. You know, I think the tempo of the game was pretty exciting. It's been that way the last few games, and a lot of team speed Orlando has, and they were thrown at us early tonight, and I thought that we did a pretty good job of getting guys back and clogging up that blue line and making them dump the puck in.
You know, you and Dave Tippett watched tapes, obviously, in the first half of the season, and now you're watching him in the second half. Night and day, it must be nice watching him as of 96.
Well, certainly things have gotten a little bit better. We've gotten, more than anything, we've got guys playing a system to a T. I mean, guys, we stress it. We've gone over it in films. Even the games we've won, points where maybe they, where we've kind of fallen away from it a little bit. The other night in the second period, we got away from it, and we kind of went back and said, okay, look, this is how we're going to win hockey games. We got to stick to it. This is something that seems to work so far, and until it falters and isn't working, we're going to do the best we can to just stick to the game plan.
Scotty, I noticed that in the Aeros system, they do a lot of good forechecking, but Orlando does good forechecking of themselves. Adam and I were just talking about that, and what have you, are you doing anything defensively different than the other games, or are you just kind of playing it the same way?
Well, as you know, it's a big secret what we're doing. We're not letting anybody know. It's, you know, we'll have to kill you if we let you know what it is. But no, it's just a case of we're trying to stack the blue line, get three guys back all the time. No matter who we're playing, we've had some good tests against Kansas City with all their speed, against a team like San Francisco, where they just played a, you know, a sort of a one-man in type thing. Once again, with Orlando, it's a lot of team speed coming at you. And we just want to make sure that we're not going to give them three on twos or two on ones. But if they want to do anything, they got to dump it in, and we got to battle down in the corners with them.
Scotty, if you had to pick out one positive thing from the first half of the season, would you say that maybe now that you guys have turned things around, and if you get into the playoffs, that's something that maybe gives you guys a little character and brings the team closer together?
Well, certainly it does. And every game we've won, we're gradually climbing up the ladder. And you know, we know it's a tough task ahead of us, but everybody's got a goal in mind. Until that goal is it reached, we're not going to be satisfied. And I think that everybody's going to be pretty secure and pretty happy once we reach that goal.
Terrific hockey game. Thanks for joining us, Scotty.
All right. Thanks, Adam. Thanks,
right.
Greeny.
Thank you. 2-1 in favor of the Houston Aeros. And when we return, we'll have highlights and stats. We're back after this. It's a 2-1 hockey game in favor of the Houston Aeros, and let's quickly get to the highlights, Greener.
Well, Orlando did start off with the scoring, and they did it early on a power play. McDonough, the guy we talked about in the pregame, he gets in, he just takes a swipe at it. It gets through Shervin, and, you know, a lot of times a goaltender won't be sure whether he should attack that puck or wait for it. I think he elected to wait for it as he gets the pass. Turcotte feeds McDonough. He just feeds it through to kind of just sneaks through, and the puck, speaking of sneaking, slips right through there. McDonough gets his 12th goal of the season from Turcotte, and the Shoulder Bears lead it 1-0, but the Aeros don't waste any time coming back, and Freer does a lot of this work right behind the net. He'll feed it out front for Arneil, and Arneil just takes a good hard shot, and on the screen, Bester can't see it. He just drops to his knees, and he is also back in his crease, if you'll notice, and Arneil just one-times it, and a great shot. Arneil gets the goal to tie the game up. That's Arneil's 15th goal of the season from Freer and Townsend. It's a tie game, and then the Aeros aren't done yet. They continue on. A good pass by Lamb. Lamb gets a pass from Conroy, and he feeds it across, and on the 5-on-3, Turgeon just lets this one rip, and it was in and out before you could even see it. A great goal by Turgeon, an even better pass by Lamb as a good one-timer, and it goes upstairs. The Aeros lead it 2-1 on Turgeon's 15th of the season from Lamb and Conroy.
All right, Aeros with a one-goal lead, and we'll have the stats when we return. Back in the Summit, Adam Gordon, Mike Greenlay, 2-1 in favor of the Aeros, and let's take a look at tonight's first period stats brought to you by your local Texas Chrysler Plymouth dealers. Shots at 10 apiece. The Aeros 1 of 2 on the power play. Orlando 0 for 2 on the man advantage. And the Aeros with 11 faceoffs. The Solar Bears with 6, and both teams 2 penalties for 4 minutes. When we return, third or second period action from the Summit. Our score, it's the Aeros 2 and the Solar Bears 1. We'll be right back. Houston Aeros Hockey on Prime Sports is being brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Fly Southwest, the low-fare airline. By your participating Texas Chrysler Plymouth, Dodge, and Jeep and Eagle dealers. By Columbia HCA Healthcare Corporation, a new commitment to healthcare together. By Texaco Clean System 3 Gasolines, add more life to your car, take it to the star. And by the Gatorade Company. If you're living life to the fullest, you're gonna get thirsty. That's why you need Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Life's a sport, drink it up. Back at the Summit, Adam Gordon along with Mike Greenlay. It is 2-1 in favor of the Houston Aeros. Goals for Houston off the sticks of Scott Arneil and Sylvain Turgeon. And here's Grant Shervin, who had a terrific first period, stopped 9 of 10, and played very well, especially after giving up the McDonough goal. And on the other end, Alan Bester getting ready to get his hockey team back into this thing, trailing 2-1. Tell you, on both goals against Alan Bester, not much he could do. You know, you mentioned the one on Scott that Scott Arneil got on him. He had to stay back because the puck was behind the net. That was just a great play for it, Arneil.
Yeah, that's one thing goaltenders do work on a lot is coming from the post out to the top of their crease. I think the reason why Bester didn't do that as much as he normally would have is because the puck came out and then he was screened, so he didn't want to come out too far. And as it was, Arneil put it over his underneath his blocker, over his pad, and they led 2-1.
You know, he's tied for the IHL in victories with 16, and he's also the top 5 in saves, minutes played as well, and he's been terrific. Dave Tippett, on the other hand, has seen his team win 3 in a row and would love to see number 4. It's 3 games in 3 nights for Dave Tippett and the Houston Aeros. And he will bring out the line of Mark Lamb, Sylvain Turgeon, and Kelly Hurd. And defensively, he'll go with Gord Krupke and Mike Hurlbutt. But now, Graham Townsend's going to go out for Kelly Hurd. So it'll be Lamb, Townsend, and Turgeon with Krupke and Hurlbutt. For the Orlando Solar Bears, they'll have Bob Joyce, Mike Hartman, and Craig Duncanson. Defensively, they line up with Brad Tiley and Jeff Circa. Aeros defend the goal to our left in the second period. The Solar Bears the goal to our right. And a face-off control by Houston. Krupke right side, turns one out at center for Townsend. Townsend moving up ice, he'll rip one right in on Bester. He'll make the save and then he will cover up and he will hold on.
So I don't think Townsend was trying to, well, I'm sure he was trying to. I don't think he expected to score from there, but what it does do is it gives the Arrows a face-off down deep in the Orlando zone really early in the second period. They already lead it 2-1, but I'm sure the Arrows would like to stretch this one by a couple more. I don't think they want to win these games in shootouts and by the skin of their teeth, as they say, right down to the end.
No. And I think if you're the Arrows, you kind of remember getting spanked a couple of times by the Solar Bears. Maybe a return to the favor, but at this point, you just take the wins any way you can get them.
It is Lamb in the face-off circle against Joyce. Lamb wins the draw back to Hurlbutt. Right side getting sent. Hurlbutt cutting in, shot, stop! It never made it to Bester. Behind the net, Lamb, bumped by Circa. Circa fighting for it. There's Bob Joyce. Jammed away, Townsend. He was run into by Hartman. Puck came out. Kershaw with a one-time shot, but he fanned on it. And Krupke back to play it. 30 seconds played in the second. And the puck is in the Orlando zone. Kershaw tossed it down in behind the net. That swatted away. Kershaw overskated the puck. Hurlbutt trying to hold it in. He's blasted into the boards by Joyce. And the Arrows regroup at center. Krupke slammed it ahead, but it was intercepted. And Hartman's got a two-on-one. Hartman winding, shooting, and his shot went wide. The Arrows, though, did a good job of getting back and turning that two-on-one into actually a two-on-three. Everybody hustling back on that. Here is Sylvain Turgeon back in his own end. He'll move it up ice. Turgeon, who won the fastest skating competition at the All-Star Skills Competition, trying to turn on the speed there. Here's Lamb across the line. Lamb lost the puck. It's picked up by Richards and shot out to center ice. Get it over, and now a chance. Fisher's in alone. Deke shoots. He scores! Craig Fisher got in alone and beat Grant Sherwin, and it's a 2-2 hockey game.
Craig Fisher's not the kind of guy you want heading in all alone. He's second in the league in points, and he's also second in scoring in 41 games. He has 31 goals coming into tonight, and he just picks up the puck all alone at the blue line, and it's clear sailing after that. He makes a couple of moves, and then he puts it underneath the pad of Sherwin. Sherwin gets his stick up and can't get a bead on this one as Craig Fisher fires one home. He gets his 32nd goal of the season and ties this game up.
And the puck is back at center ice, and here comes Beauvais again across the line with Fisher. Fisher moving in, but that swatted away. Back to the line, Richards over for Frederick, and his one-time shot wide. Now the puck out in front, and Kelly Hertz slides it out at center. Back to play it, it is Ferner. Now it is turned out along the boards. Here's Mark Beauvais turning left side, sends one down, Sherwin the stick save. And it's picked up by Miles O'Connor. A headman pass for Kelly Hurd, and Donnelly shoots to center. Here's Arneil with Freer. Arneil moving down the left side, trying to move in, but Ferner back to turn it away. Ferner on defense, near side, pushed it out at center. 3-on-2 for Orlando. Here is Richards, pulls up, shoots, Sherwin save, rebound. Pushed to the far side. So the Arrows have gotten off to a similar slow start here in the second like they did against Chicago. Kelly Hurd right side the shot, and a stick save made by Bester. Puck is clear to the line and out at center for Craig Fisher. He had 3 assists against Indianapolis on Wednesday, or actually I should say he had 2 assists. He's got 3 assists in his last 2 games. And now the goal, and it's tied at 2. 2.5 gone in the second. And it's controlled by Circa. Pass for Huey McDonough. He'll move it through the neutral zone. McDonough slides it into the arrow, and it came right back, got through the skates of Sherwin. Oh, he's making everything a little bit of an adventure tonight. Puck is out at center, and now Maurice with a chance. In on Neaton, but he lost the puck. That is over 2 lines. And the faceoff will come back to center ice.
And Sherwin mishandles the puck a little bit, and I think he was trying to set it up for his defenseman. It ended up going off the heel of his stick and rattling around in between his skates. The puck eventually was cleared up to Mike Maurice, and Mike Maurice got the pass on a 2-line offside pass. And so Dave Tippett's Arrows will come back down into their own zone just inside the blue line.
Face-off will be between Al Conroy and Hubie McDonough. And it is a 2-2 hockey. Mark Lagniel over at the bench getting a new stick. That's why the delay. Oh, he's getting a goaltender stick. That's what it is. No, Lanny, you can't play with that. You got to give that to Grant Sherwin. And he will. Well, what a job Grant Sherwin has done since coming in. 6th consecutive start for Grant Sherwin. I call him the human band-aid because he's kind of stopped the bleeding for the Arrows in goal. And this band-aid definitely sticks where it's supposed to. Puck is in the arrow end, and Sherbin will cover up and hold on again.
Shot there right through the screen, and Sherbin having to be sharp, getting his stick down on the ice. Two of the goals that have beat him tonight have been five hole. Stick has been up and out of the way. That's one thing that a goaltender likes to try and do more often than not, is keep his stick right down on the ice. The faceoff, the puck comes right back, and Neaton just winds up and shoots one, and it kind of goes through a screen, but Sherbin this time does have the stick down, and he covers up the rebound. Faceoff will come to his right.
And it'll be Mark Lamb against Neil Eisenhut. Eisenhut with Barr and Joyce, so obviously Kurt Frazier has turned his lines around here a little bit to shake things up after being winless in three coming into tonight's hockey game. Lamb is out there with Graham Townsend and Sylvain Turgeon, and the Arrows win the draw. Pop behind the net for Mark Lanyell, and he'll turn it up ice. Lanyell, a pass for Mark Lamb. He'll hoist that high, and the Arrow bounce into the corner to the right of Bester. Back to play at Circa. Now Turgeon moving down. Turgeon centered, and then Lamb was turned on. That's got to be a penalty, and it will. Sherbin will be back to play it as the Arrows will get an extra attacker as soon as Houston moves it away. It's pushed to the near side. Sherbin will come to the bench. Graham Townsend pushed it ahead, but Dave Barr will play it. And it'll be a penalty coming up when we return. Our score from the Summit. It's the Arrows 2, the Solar Bears 2, back after this. But first, this word from Southwest Airlines. It's a 2-2 hockey game as Pat Neaton is in the box for the Orlando Solar Bears for hooking. And that takes us to our high-low rule book. And hooking is when a player uses his stick or the blade of his stick to hook an opponent. And that is what has happened to Pat Neaton. And the Arrows are going to be on their third power play of the night. They're 1-of-2 on the man advantage. Sylvain Turgeon scoring the power play goal. In fact, he now has goals in his last three contests. And in his last two, his goals have come off the power play. And both have come off one-timers. Although Wednesday's is more of a deflection, but I'll call that a one-timer. Here come the Arrows through the neutral zone. Yo fires it into the Orlando, and Turgeon pursues. Bester played it away. It came to the line for Mark Lamb. Right point moved it down. It was knocked away. Circa pushed it ahead. Buffet and his pass just missing McDonough. McDonough the only guy back, so Sherbin's going to play it away for a waiting Miles O'Connor. O'Connor sends it behind the net for Lamb. Ooh, turned over to Buffet. Here's Buffet turning in front. McDonough shoots. Great save, Sherbin. He will hold on. McDonough burned the Arrows for a shorthanded goal the last time the two teams played in Orlando. But this time, Sherbin came up big. It is O'Connor. Fired it into the Orlando zone. Circa back to play it. Tipped it through the defense. Now it is controlled. Lamb sends it down. It was deflected over to Turgeon. Turgeon right side getting set. Turgeon back to Lamb. Here's Turgeon right point getting set. Walking in. Waiting. Lamb winds. Let the shot go. Lamb gets it back. Here's Turgeon. Waiting some more. Arrows need to shoot the puck. Lamb's got 54 on the power play. Jammed it back. Here's O'Connor the drive. Great save by Bester. Turgeon. Oh, Bester again. They'll bang away at it. Bester got in front of another one. That's three nice saves by Bester. Lamb shoots. Deflected over the glass and out of play. 41 seconds left in Eaton. And the game is tied at two. Alan Bester doing some terrific net minding.
Mark Lamb doing a good job feeding the tops of the circles there where Turgeon is. Eventually, Miles O'Connor does get the puck on a pass from Conroy, and he just tees it up and lets it go. Bester makes a great save on this, and good job by Turgeon getting on it right away. Yo's in front, fighting for it, but no one can get a handle on it as it's chopped around. Eventually, the puck will come back to the point, and it'll be deflected up over the glass, so the faceoff will come to the top of the circle. Mark Freer to take it.
Freer against Eisenhut, 41 on the power play. Sticks are down, and they joust, and drop of the puck, and the Arrows have got it. Hurlbutt, right point, the shot high and wide of the net. Now Duncanson turning, he'll chip it out at center, and Hurlbutt back to play it. Mike Hurlbutt along the left side, knocked it ahead, but Duncanson took it away. Duncanson for Eisenhut. That's pushed in there, and now a penalty coming up to Scott Arneil. He got a little physical with Eisenhut, knocked him off, and the penalty will go to Scott Arneil. And with just about 5 minutes gone in the second period and the game tied at two, Orlando will get their third power play of the evening in 25 seconds.
They're 0 for 2 right now, and Scott Arneil takes a penalty for holding 2 minutes. And the Bears go on, like I said, their third power play of the game. Arneil gets hooked up with Eisenhut a little too much, and Eisenhut drops, but I don't think that necessarily was the reason. I think Arneil had a hold of his stick and
So he'll sit in the box, and Orlando will get a chance to take the lead. The Arrows didn't start the scoring. Orlando did, but then they came back with two goals. Orlando has since tied it up in this period, and now they'll try and go and take another lead like they did right off the bat.
Arrows have the puck in their own end. It's Steve Jakes turning behind the cage, and he'll send it over to Lanyell. Puck tipped away, Freer trying to move it ahead. It was knocked away. And the Solar Bears have got it to the line. The drive ricocheted wide. Picked up by Richards. Turned it down along the boards. In 3 seconds, the Bears will be on the power play. Frank Fisher trying to move it to Maurice. Can't happen. It goes deep in the corner. And now the Solar Bears on their third power play, but Houston with it. And Jakes will slide it ahead. Here's Freer. Two on two with Maurice shorthanded. Dumped the puck in. Back to play it. Ferner. He'll go behind that. Besker swats that away. And the Solar Bears are off the center. The pass over to Fisher. He overskated it. Ferner's got it now. Ferner watched by Maurice. Ferner pulls up base right circle, centered. Oh, the shot was deflected away. It came along the near boards for Fisher. Scooped it down into the corner. Dave Barr is there. Barr getting set. It was sent out in front, but tipped away by Donnelly, and down the ice it goes. 1 minute remaining on the power play for the Solar Bears. They'll control. Ferner in his own end for Orlando. Pushed it ahead for Hubie McDonough. He's got a goal in the hockey game. McDonough cuts to the left side. Rolled it in behind the net. It goes along the far side. Richards trying to hold. He was bumped by Yo. Donnelly's got it. Donnelly swats that ahead. It was tipped away. Fisher trying to move out in front. Sherman poked that away. And here's Yo, who will clear it back to center ice.
Normally when Orlando sets up, they like to get it to their point men and not necessarily shoot it on goal, but feed those guys on the back door. They were doing that a lot in the first period, but the Arrows haven't allowed them to set up in this second period.
At center, it is Alfie Turcotte in across the line. Dropped at LeBlanc. He's got McDonough in front. The shot stops. Sherman loose in front. Here's the shot. They score. Pat Neaton, a power play goal. And the Solar Bears lead it 3-2.
Just one too many chances in front. Sherman made a couple saves right off the bat. But the puck does come out to the slot, and Neaton is standing right there, gets the puck on his stick. Sherman tried to get back into position, but didn't have enough time. A good shot by LeBlanc and a great save by Sherman to get his stick down in time. The puck was tried to clear it, was Donnelly in front. Donnelly eventually cleared it, but right to the stick of Neaton, and Neaton just puts it up over top of the blocker. It's his third goal of the season and a power play goal.
First power play goal of the night for the Solar Bears. And they have now taken a 3-2 lead on two unanswered goals in the second period. Doldrums a little bit continue to bite this Houston Aero Hockey Club. They struggled a little bit in the second period against Chicago and also against Kansas City in KC. And they have yet to score in this period as they trail 3-2 now. Here's Mark Lamb in his own end. Lamb tossed the puck ahead. Neaton back to play it, pursued by Turgeon. But Brad Tiley is there. Tiley left side, worked it ahead. It goes into the arrow end and Hurlbutt back to play. Fired it off the glass, and Pat Neaton will play it. Neaton turned the puck ahead for Joyce. Ooh, turned it over. Here come the Arrows. A pass, Lamb, give it to Kelly Hurd. Hurd left side, drops Turgeon. Turgeon spins it back to Hurlbutt. Left point, tees it up, shoots, and that went wide of the net. Krupke's got it right point. Turned it down for Lamb. Behind for Kelly Hurd. Base in the right circle. Hurd trying to move it down for Lamb. He worked on by Neaton. Here is Hurd. Centered in front. Krupke can't get the shot away. Now it is Hurd. Tell you what, Arrows give up a couple of goals, but they're right back after the Solar Bears. In the corner, Lamb to the line. Hurlbutt tipped it to Turgeon. Sliced it down, but Duncanson was there. Can he get it out of the zone? Yes, he will. It's out at center for Hartman. He'll fire it into the arrow end, and Houston back to play it with 12:14 to go in the second period. A 3-2 hockey game. And the pass came out at center off the skates of Turgeon, who's a little late in the shift. Here's Mark Buffet, right side, dropped it. Todd Richards in, stopped by Sherman. Here's the shot, they score! It was either Fisher or Buffet, and the Solar Bears open up a two-goal lead. It's 4-2.
I think it might have been Fisher that finally got the backhand on it, and you're starting to see the types of goals that the kind of goals that the goaltenders earlier on in the season, Dobson and Gamble, were facing. Richards walks in, a good backhand, a save is made, and then the rebound right to Fisher. It actually goes off of Freer's toe right into the net. But that kind of pressure, those kind of rebound shots, right here, the shot, the save, but then the rebound will come to the left of Sherman. It'll go off of Freer's skate right into the net. And that kind of pressure Orlando likes to put on teams. They're a very explosive team, and they've shown that in this period.
Three unanswered goals, and they lead it 4-2. Here's a centering pass. Arneal can't get the shot away. And they'll scamper to center. Orlando at neutral ice. Fisher across the line. Scraped by Jakes. And it's turned around by Houston. Slipchenko. And Slipchenko was drilled by Frederick. Freer across the line. Dropped it back. That is offsides. And we need to take a timeout. 11:34 to go in the second period. It's the Solar Bears 4, the Arrows 2. Houston Arrows hockey back after this. Along with Mike Greenlay, Adam Gordon with you from the Summit. Solar Bears lead it by a score of 4-2 with 11:34 remaining in the second period. Freer with Slivchenko and Arneal with Jenks and Lanyell. Here's Steve Jenks at center ice. A pass over to Lanyell. He'll turn it ahead for Arneal and escorts it into the Orlando zone. Todd Richards back to play it. He takes a bump from Freer. Freer sends it over to Arneal. Here's Lanyell winding, shooting, stop. Ooh, Slivchenko on the doorstep, but couldn't get a shot away. And it's shot right back out at center. Lanyell drills it into the Orlando zone. Vester slows. Behind the net, Circa. He'll play the puck from right to left as the Arrows set up in their forecheck. Here is Circa, the pass came up the middle for Duncanson. It's kicked to center. Arrows trying to move it away, and it's knocked away by Houston out at center ice. Richards ripped it into the Arrow end. Shervin will slow behind the net. And Jakes, ooh, miscommunicated with Shervin. Puck came out in front, but the Arrows have got it. Freer at neutral ice gives it to Arneal too far. And the Solar Bears are back, and Ferner will shoot it to center. Jakes popped it into the Orlando zone. Neaton trying to catch the Arrows in a line change. Can't get the pass ahead for Dave Barr, and the Arrows are back. Miles O'Connor, center ice for Mike Yeo. Yeo, give it to Maurice, tipped it for Conroy. Conroy centered it, but nobody there. Yeo after it in the corner. Yeo, give it to Al Conroy. Left wing, centered it, but it was tipped away by Eisenhut and cleared to center ice Duncanson. Duncanson rolled the puck ahead for Alfie Turcotte, and it goes into the Arrow end. 10:13 to go in the second. Solar Bears lead it by a score of 4-2. Or it is O'Connor. Give it to Yeo. He'll work it out at neutral ice. McDonough trying to play it. Conway fired it ahead. But there was LeBlanc to get it into the Arrow end. Donnelly. Cross ice pass. Conway couldn't find the handle. LeBlanc across the line. Here's McDonough cutting into the slot. The shot ricocheted wide of the net. And Maurice is there. Mike Maurice trying to turn one ahead. Turcotte pumped it away. And they battle for it. Maurice along the near side. And it finally goes into the Orlando zone. Ferner along the boards, and the puck was hemmed in there, and they'll blow play dead with 9:41 to go in the second period. And it is 4-2 in favor of the Orlando Solar Bears. Well, coming up on UPN 20, a special edition of Saturday Night on Ice, this Sunday from the Delta Center. It's the Arrows and the Utah Grizzlies, defending Turner Cup champions. And if you are looking for some good news for the Houston Arrows in that particular hockey game, Tommy Sallow is up. Nicholas Anderson is up. I believe Danton Cole is still up with the Islanders. And hopefully that guy there will be ready to go, Grant Shervin.
I haven't been in Salt Lake in a couple of years. It'll be good to hit that town again.
When you were there, it wasn't the Delta Center, though. It was the Salt Palace.
No, it was the Delta Center.
Was it?
Yep, certainly was.
Did they have it for you when you played? Jeez, did they wear helmets when you played?
No, I'm still a kid.
Oh, brother, I'm going to hear about that after this broadcast is over, which could be my last. Here's Ferner back in his own end. Turning in behind the cage. Ooh, Kelly Hurd nearly knocked that away. Kelly Hurd almost went for the knee there. The Solar Bears wanting a penalty. And they may have time. Into the Arrow end. Here's Gord Donnelly in behind the cage, and he'll set the rush up. Donnelly, quick pass out to the left side for Lamb. Now it is Sylvain Turgeon across the line with Hurd. Turgeon bumped off the puck. Joe Frederick turned it away. And Jeff Circa controlled. Circa, left side, moved it out at center. Freer knocked it down. Freer, give it to Kelly Hurd. It's 2-on-1. Hurd upstairs, he scores! Great goal, Kelly Hurd! And the Arrows are within 1-4-3.
That's one thing that I like to see is the Arrows are unrelenting. They keep coming back. And that is Kelly Hurd's first goal as a Houston Arrow, coming at a great time. He puts it up into the top corner. That's Kelly Hurd's sixth goal of the season, first as a Houston Arrow, as he gets a good wrist shot weighed up high. And Vester gave him a little too much on the blocker side. Great angle right here.
Bester gives a little too much, and Hurd makes no doubt about it as he puts it off the post. He had Turgeon streaking in there as well.
You know what? That shot is very similar to the one Bob Joyce had. The difference is, what a difference half an inch makes. Half an inch to the right for Kelly Hurd. It's into the net. Half an inch to the left for Bob Joyce, and it's going.
It is a game of inches or half inches, whichever way you want to look at it. And the Arrows are within one. It's a great goal, and I think Duncanson right now is arguing the what Hurd hit Ferner in front of the net a couple plays previous to that goal, and Ferner has been on the bench ever since. I haven't seen him leave the ice yet, but I think that might have been what they were arguing about.
Puck is controlled by Orlando. Tiley give it to Cirk in his own end, and a pass at center. And a lead shot from Buffet, and it was knocked away, and Slavchenko turns at center. Slavchenko looking for Freer, and the Solar Bears move it ahead. Here is Buffet, right pass, in front, centered. Hurlbutt knocked that away, and here comes Slavchenko speeding it neutral. Slavchenko across the line, dropped it for Freer. Here's Freer, right in! Shot stopped by Bester, it got behind him. He will cover up, and he will hold on. It's a 4-2 hockey game in favor of the Solar Bears. More IHL action after this.
We'll be back.
It's 4-3, the Solar Bears leading the Houston Arrows, and Greener, another chance for Mark Freer.
Well, Mark Freer tried to tie this one up. He gets a great drop pass and just feeds it through, and Bester gets a piece of it, and it drops down and behind him. But once again, Bester looks behind him and finds it before it bounces across the line. He's had a couple of those that have kind of rolled towards that line very perilously, but he's been up to the task as he grabs it and keeps the score 4-3 for the Orlando Solar Bears. Freer getting a good hard shot on goal. And Slavchenko setting up that play nicely. Actually, Slavchenko, in the four games he's played against the Solar Bears, is leading with 2 goals and 2 assists. So he must have their number. I'd like to see him out there maybe a little more, getting those kind of plays going.
Well, he was the extra forward tonight, and Dave Tippett sitting him down, trying to get him going, and perhaps giving him that first period off to look around a little bit, and now getting him up with Freer and Arneal. That's going to make that line a little more volatile. Here is a pass that came out at center, and the Arrows have got it. Hurlbutt jammed it into the Orlando zone, and Bester will slow. Todd Richards behind the cage, and he will bring it out for Mike the left. Pat Neaton jammed it through Kelly Hurd. It's out at center, and Krupke trying to fire it ahead. Eisenhut had that popped away, and here's Krupke. Krupke turning it center ice, fired it into the Orlando zone. Back to play at Bester, and he'll leave it for Neaton. He lost the net. Ashton Byrne, it's tipped out in front. Lamb turning, and it was pushed away to the line, not out. Krupke held it in. Krupke tossed it in behind Kelly Hurd, was shouldered off the puck by Richards. They battle for it behind the cage. They continue to grind it out. Here is Lamb playing peekaboo behind the net. Centered, it hit skates, and Bester not taking any chances, and he will hold on. 7:23 to go in the second period. It's the Solar Bears leading by a score of 4-3. Fans, get an early start on your Mardi Gras celebrating. You don't have to go all the way to New Orleans to come to the summit. Hey, Friday, February 2nd, the Rice Marching Owl Band will be on hand along with the 104 KRB Stick Brigade. For your entertainment, everyone entering the building will receive the ever-popular Mardi Gras beads. That's Friday, February 2nd at 7 p.m. Check out your Houston Chronicle that day for game coupons. And Al Conroy, who had a huge goal against Chicago. And, you know, Al Conroy was one guy that was a little upset when Dave Tippett called it quits as far as a player goes, but he's got to be thrilled that he's got Tippett on the bench. He played with him in Philadelphia and, of course, played with him a little bit last year here in Houston. Jakes, he'll play the puck. Jakes is screened by Joe Frederick. Jakes giving Frederick a little look, and the puck is cleared out at center. Puck is controlled by Tiley. Well, that's the second time Frederick's kind of gone in, maybe just a hair late. He went in on Hurl, but it cost him two. This time it didn't. Here is Fisher across the line, tossed it down, and Sherman's not going to take many chances there. He's going to just cover up and hold on. The 6:53 goal, and now Conroy gets bumped from behind. This is the first we've seen of the pushing and shoving as Laniel getting into it with Bob Joyce. And the linesman getting in there to separate. This all started when a Solar Bear pushed Al Conroy from behind, and then everybody gathering and handing out business cards.
Well, it was Beaufay that kind of started the pushing and shoving, but I'm sure it stemmed from something a little earlier on in the play. It's going to get a little bit chippy probably coming into this late part of the second period. Both teams seem to be putting quite a bit of pressure on, and they're, you know, Conroy gives them a little bit of the rub. Ah, a little bit of the rub.
And Beaufay gives him a good shot. And then he goes after Joyce, maybe stirring some things up, trying to get a late hit by Orlando, trying to get a power play going to get that tie.
Face off right side of Grant Shervin. Craig Fisher against Mark Freer. They joust a little bit, and then Freer will be tossed out of the circle. So Scott Arneal, who has a goal in the hockey game, he'll face off against Fisher. Or that's Barr. She looked like 17. It's Barr, 11. Here's Joyce, the shot that goes wide. Goes to the far side. Freer back to play. Mark Freer turned it back behind the net for Laniel. He was met by Duncanson. Off the head, Townsend, who was pushed by Joyce. Joyce near side. He'll fire it in behind the arrow net. Back to play it is Steve Jakes. Give it up for Arneal. Couldn't clear the zone, and Jakes back to play it again. He'll rumble in behind the net. Give it over to Laniel. He'll fire it off the glass. It's back at center ice. Joyce over to Brad Tiley in his own end. Goes toward the arrow line. That's intercepted by Arneal. And here come the Houston Arrows. Freer across the blue line. Shoots Dexter. The blocker save. And it's controlled by Kiley. And shot to center ice. Here's Laniel. Had it swatted away by Hartman. It goes behind the net. Shervin. He'll stop. Now Dave Barr in the corner. Hit by Arneal. Battle for the puck in the corner. Arneal and Barr skate to skate. There's a couple of wily veterans. Got a 13-year professional in Arneal and a 15-year guy in Dave Barr. Hartman trying to move one in there, and it's back to the line, not out. Duncanson shoots, blocked in front. Getting in front of that was Gord Donnelly. We haven't seen that at all, right? That's all he does, gets in front of shots. I shouldn't say that's all he does, but boy.
That's one of the reasons why I became a goalie. When I was a kid, I played defense, and I got in front of all the shots in front of net. They threw me in net. Maybe Donnelly wants to throw the pads on.
We have some lovely parting gifts for you. Not. Here is Yo. He'll turn in his own end. Yo had to get it back from O'Connor, and now it is Conroy with Maurice across the line. Conroy trying to move in. Conroy along the far boards. Neaton is in there, and it is controlled by Hubie McDonough. Rolling out to Turcotte. Center ice, cross ice, pass intercepted by Donnelly, and here come the arrows. Donnelly for Conroy. Tipped into the Orlando zone. Neaton to play it. Neaton turned it far side for Alfie Turcotte. He'll pop it ahead. O'Connor held it in. Turcotte again, but it's taken back by Conroy. He centered it, but Besker will cover up, and he will hold on. 4:59 to go in the second period. It's the Solar Bears 4, the Arrows 3. We'll be right back after this. Along with Mike Greenlay, Adam Gordon with you. Solar Bears lead it by a score of 4-3 with just about 5 minutes remaining. And, you know, three games in three nights, tough for the Houston Arrows. Look at the record of the teams they've got to play. Orlando, 26-11-4. Then tomorrow, they're in Vegas, where they have not won this year. 38-5. And the Utah Grizzlies, 27-11-2. And I'll tell you what, if the Arrows can go 2-1 on this weekend, I think they will be very happy with that.
Well, I'm sure Dave Tippett realizes that he does have a tough road ahead, but it will, as he said before, give him a good read on where his team's at. If you can show good competitiveness with these kind of teams, then you show that yourself that you've improved a bit.
He made a good point. He said, let's get this going now as opposed to later. This way I got more time to make adjustments to find out where I'm at. If you're doing it the last couple of weeks of the season, that doesn't give you a lot of time if you're trying to make the playoffs. No time. Here is a puck controlled by Maurice, and he'll turn it out to the line, not out. Held in, neat in the drive. That was blocked by, guess who? Yes, Gord Donnelly. Now the puck is turned ahead. Yo, give it to Conroy. Conroy, right side, shoots it in, and Besker is playing it away. In behind the net, Neaton. Neaton turning in his own end. Here is Cirka. Cirka trying to move it ahead across the line with McDonough. He's trying to spring McDonough down the right side. Getting it tackled into the corner by Conroy. And those two trying to separate him. Here is a puck that's out at neutral ice. Yo, spun off, turned ahead, and pushed. Hey, things are really getting chippy here as Conroy and McDonough are going at it. McDonough, ooh, with a left hand on Conroy. The play moving on. Here's Tiley trying to move it through. Boy, look at Conroy and McDonough go at it in front of the net. Here is a chance. Frederick snapped it back. Tiley winds, shoots, hammered right in there. Shervin the save. And then Conroy rub-a-dub-dub under the face of Hughie McDonough. And everybody getting into it.
Well, you can see this one escalating all the way through the play. And
look at Tiley moving.
Well, Tiley better watch himself or he'll get tossed. He can't jump in there no matter what. Don't want any third man in. That would help the Arrows, of course. But those guys have been going at it the whole play. And finally, it escalated into a bit of a wrestling match. And everyone gets in on it. But that just shows the aggressiveness of both teams right now. They're both jumping into the play quite nicely, moving the puck very good and putting pressure on each other. There really hasn't been one team that's dominated the play for, 5 to 10 minutes of any period. They've both shown good scoring possibilities. And they've also shown that they can get in with the rough stuff. Here's a good shot of how things started. It started in the corner as they both pile up, and from here, from this point on, all the way down into that, when they piled up into the net, McDonough gives him a punch in the head, and just from there on, Conroy rides him the rest of the play. He'll pick him up in the slot again and ride him right towards the net, and then give him a little face rub after the play is over. A good save by Shervin. Hey, we forgot about the hockey game.
Yeah. By the way, Shervin made a save.
It was a good hard slap shot, and Shervin makes a save. And you watch Conroy just give him a little rub in the face, letting him know that you're not going to be able to get away with that kind of stuff too often.
So Conroy in the box along with Gord Donnelly, as they will each pick up, I'm sure, some roughing minors. Joe Frederick and Hughie McDonough off the ice. I'll tell you, you hate to lose an Al Conroy for a couple of minutes here, but in the same sense, he takes Hughie McDonough with him. So a face-off at center after all that. Kurt Fraser, the head coach, not happy about this. He was out by his doorstep.
Well, I think what he saw is Conroy riding McDonough the rest of the play on. What he probably did not see is McDonough punching Conroy in the face deep in the corner there, as I didn't even see that. I was watching them and I didn't see it. It was a kind of a quick jab, and Conroy didn't like it. And so now Fraser's letting Scott Hansen know all about it.
I wonder if he's still barking. You had the Cali Herd play where he went for the knee of, I believe it was Ferner. And then another play, I can't remember who it was, at the blue line nearly knocked knees with an arrow. And then you've got Conroy's escapade there with McDonough. I wonder if he's just wondering if Scotty Hansen's letting things go too much. I'm only speculating. I know. All right.
The opinions expressed by Adam Gordon are
worth a plum nickel. Not even that.
But we still do have a very good hockey game. It's 4-3 for the Solar Bears. And like I said before, there hasn't been really any domination by either team. Both teams have had great chances, and it's still a pretty good hard-hitting game.
Puck is shot ahead into the Orlando zone. Kiley back to play it. Down near side, Hartman. Hartman will skate away. Here comes Hartman to center ice in a 4-3 Orlando lead. Ripped the shot, Shervin save, and a big rebound came out, and Freer will play it. I've noticed Shervin giving up a few more rebounds tonight. Is that any reason to have concern at all?
Well, the types of rebounds are off of those kind of shots. Those kind of shots are always hard to control if they're right at you. The shot comes right at you and you lay your pad down and there's nowhere else to put the rebound except straight back out. And that's basically sometimes a game plan by the opposing team. Orlando comes in and they wind up and shoot it.
There's kind of a forgotten man all of a sudden. Graham Townsend, remember the play he had after coming back from the loan from Minnesota? And sort of the forgotten man offensively, but still kind of doing the other things away from the puck pretty well, using his size.
Well, and that's a thing you're going to see with the kind of system. I mean, Arneil talked about it in the first intermission there. They're always going to have a guy back. They're always going to worry about defense first. And when you do that, it kind of closes things down a little bit. An open style of game isn't necessarily what the Arrows want. And when you play that kind of style, you're going to find that guys that maybe were getting goals earlier might not be getting as many now. But as long as you're winning the games, I'm sure the individual doesn't necessarily matter in that case.
Puck goes down into the Houston Arrow end, and Krupke's there to play it. Krupke to Kelly Hurd as the Arrows in their own end will shoot it out at center. Joyce had it go off his stick. Turgeon in there fighting for it. Lamb trying to pop it loose. And here's Sylvain Turgeon. Turgeon at center trying to move the puck ahead, and he goes after Joyce. Joyce went after him, and now those two go at one another, and we're going to get a penalty. Here's LeBlanc right in, and he missed the net. Penalty coming up to Sylvain Turgeon. He thinks Joyce should get one as well, but it's going to be Turgeon, the only man that'll go.
Well, earlier on in that play by the penalty box, when Joyce was along the boards, Turgeon went up to hit him, and Joyce stepped away from the puck and went after him, hit him, then took the puck. So exactly the same thing that happened on the other side. Turgeon is coming towards the boards, and he just steps away from the puck and gives it to Joyce.
Now that was clean. That wasn't the penalty.
Well, I know, but that's what the situation was.
Now you see Joyce coming after Turgeon, and the puck, you can see the puck not even anywhere near the play, but Turgeon steps away and Joyce comes after him. So Turgeon steps into him with a good hit. But right before that, on the other side, there was the same situation. And then that, in turn, Turgeon gets a slashing penalty as he, I think, gave Joyce a little bit of a stick afterwards. But kind of a carbon copy plays on both ends. But Turgeon comes out with a penalty with the extra stick work.
So the Orlando Solar Bears, one of four on the power play. This is number five. We're making one of three. This is number four, pardon me. Puck is back. I'm giving him one too many. Fix that for me, would you? Here's Tiley. He'll play it in his own end. More check by Freer. Give it over to Richards out at center for Dave Barr. Barr turning it neutral ice, trying to bring it across the line through Arneal. Dave Barr shot it ahead. Barr dropped it Fisher. It went behind the net. Kupke trying to fling it ahead. It popped to the near side for Mark Beaufay. Beaufay trying to slice one out. Rink wide pass. Stopped and then cut across as Fisher tried to redirect. Now back to the line. It is Todd Richards getting set for Mark Beaufay. Beaufay slides it down for Barr. Tip Beaufay in the corner. Barr trying to move it ahead. Hurl, but tossed the body into him. There's a minute 14 left on the power play. Richards winding, shooting, Shervin saving, rebound, Shervin saving, rebound, score! Craig Fisher! It's another power play goal, and it is 5-3 Orlando.
Once again, Fisher is sniffing around. That's one thing he's good at, is coming around late and finding those extra rebounds. Shervin made a great save on the second shot. The first one was relatively routine as he dropped down and makes a pad save on Richards. But look at the save he makes off of the rebound. But then Fisher breaks in all alone and makes no doubt about it as he pots it upstairs. And Fisher gives him another two-goal blot. And Shervin really had no chances. He makes one save, two saves, and then would have had to have made three saves as Lamb tries to get in there and help out, I believe. But to no avail. The Orlando Solar Bears lead it 5-3.
2 minutes remaining in the period. Lamb, Townsend, Yeo with Laniel and Jake. So the Arrows have given up four goals in the second period. Once again, it's been their Achilles heel the second period. But the third has been their strong one, and they're going to need a strong one. Here's the puck controlled by Shervin in behind the net. Shervin fires it along the boards for Yeo. He's pinned up there by Eisenhut. Hartman trying to pick it from the scrum. Slides it down in the corner for Duncanson. Here is Eisenhut, centered for Hartman, knocked away. And the Arrows will move to center. Graham Townsend, right wing boards. Across the line, he'll shoot the puck in. Townsend plays it base of the right circle behind the net for Mark Lamb. Run into by Circa. Duncanson is there. Duncanson trying to move it ahead. Here is Townsend. Graham Townsend along the left side. Waiting. Give it to Lamb in the corner. Back Townsend shooting. Stopping was Bester. And the Solar Bears are there to clear it. Mike Hartman shot it out at center ice. Now the puck brought in by Jakes into the Orlando zone with 1:14 to go in the second period. 5-3 Solar Bears, and the puck was tipped up out of play. And a faceoff remaining in the Orlando zone with 1:11 to go in the second. 5-3 Orlando.
I'm sure that Craig Fisher is thanking the power plays that they've had tonight. The Orlando Solar Bears are number one in the league on the power play at 24.9% coming into tonight's game. And on the road, they're even better at 26%. Craig Fisher, three goals tonight, and one, the last one, coming on the power play.
He was the runner-up for Player of the Month in November. He was also the IHL Player of the Week in the week of November 20th through the 26th. And you remember, he had that big five-point night against the Arrows earlier in the year. And he was always a top scorer with Indianapolis last year. And Donnie Waddell, the general manager of the Solar Bears, wasted no time getting a guy like that into his lineup.
Well, he certainly is one of the big leaders as far as goal scoring on the team. As I mentioned earlier, he's second in the league in scoring with, he came into the game with 31 goals. He now has 34. And if Daniel Shank, who is leading the league in goals, doesn't get any goals, then he will be tied with the league lead again. He was leading a little while ago. Of course, he is second in the league in points coming into the game with 63. So a guy like that, you don't want to leave alone too often in front of your net.
Puck is behind the cage. And here is Mike Maurice trying to move one out. Centered Arneal. Oh, couldn't pull the trigger. Now Maurice trying to feather one out in front. That's pushed along. And here is a pass at center for Craig Fisher. Fisher tipped one ahead. It goes into the Houston Arrow end. 40 seconds remaining, and the Arrows are down by two. Todd Richards rips one into Houston Aero territory. Koepke wants to play it. It got through him and out at center ice. Brad Tiley watched by Freer. Tiley trying to move it ahead. Maurice along the right side feathered it into the Orlando zone as the Aeros make changes for the final 20 seconds. Freer right side. Threw one behind the net. Forte gets one ahead and it's back out at center ice. Donnelly. Right side, shoots it into the Orlando zone. Buffet goes back with 10 seconds. Buffet moves it out at center ice, and that will be the period. 2 seconds left, and the Houston Aeros will take a deficit of two into the intermission after the Solar Bears outscore them 4-1 in that period. So Dave Tippett with some adjustments to make coming out in the third period. When we return, we've got second intermission activities for you. Our score after 40 minutes of action from the Summit, it's the Orlando Solar Bears 5, the Houston Aeros 3. Back after this. The Solar Bears leading the Houston Aeros by a score of 5-3. Adam Gordon, Mike Greenlade back at the Summit.
Well, I guess you look at the five spot and maybe Grant Shervin is a breathing human being.
Well, I think when a goaltender makes the first save and then the second save and they score on maybe the second or third shot, yeah, you are human. You only can make so many saves. And I'm not putting all the onus on necessarily on the defense, but sometimes the rebounds are not where you want to put them.
And we'll see one goal coming up here in the highlights that will show it's not really Grant Sherman's fault, but let's get right into how the Solar Bears started in that second period.
Well, they did it with Fisher, and Fisher, you know, comes in all alone. He just tucks it five hole on Sherman, and that tied the game at two. It was, he got the puck from Beaufay and Duncanson, and after that, Turcotte gives it to John LeBlanc. LeBlanc gets a good shot on goal. The rebound comes right out front, and they chop away at it. Finally, it comes to Neaton, and Neaton just tucks this one right up over the blocker. That's a power play goal. It's 3-2 Solar Bears from Turcotte and LeBlanc. They didn't waste any time because they came right back. And this time, it's Richards in front. The rebound will come out front. We talked about the rebounds. This one goes off of Freer's skate. That was Fisher again in front from Richards and Beaufay at 11:58. It's 4-2 for the Solar Bears, but the Aeros don't give up. They come back, and Kelly Hurd comes down on a two-on-one with Turgeon, and he makes it count, puts it right inside the bar, and that makes it 4-3. Kelly Hurd, his first goal is an Arrow, and he gets that pass from Freer at 8:41. But then the Solar Bears come right back. A good hard shot from the point by Richards, a save made. Then the rebound is stopped as well as Barr gets a good shot. But hey, guess who's there again? It's Fisher with his third of the night. And they lead it 5-3 on his 34th goal at 2:01.
And with this 5-3 lead, Greener, you know, you look at the third period coming up. I'm sure Dave Tippett saying, hey, we're in this hockey game. Orlando is a talented hockey club. Don't kid yourself. But the Aeros have shown this year they can play with Orlando. I think the Aeros just need to stick with their system, keep coming after them, maybe get one goal to make it a one-goal game and see what they can do. The third period has been terrific for them all year.
Well, it certainly has. They have to, I guess, keep some faith in their system, go down and put some pressure on them. But, hey, take care of your own end first. Take care of your goaltender, and he'll take care of you.
What do you think, then, coming out in the third period? I would have to say that perhaps the first 5 minutes here, the Aeros really need to come out and establish the tempo. That's been the problem, I think, in the second period. They kind of get caught back a little bit to start the second frame.
Well, like I said, neither team has really dominated play, but I think the Orlando Solar Bears obviously dominated the goal-scoring column in that period. They're going to have to come and actually put some pucks in the net. We talked about that as our first key of the game. I think they're going to have to do that, come out and actually score some goals and get back into this hockey game.
All right, Greener, 5-3. The Solar Bears lead it. We'll look at the statistics from that period when we return. Back of the Summit, Adam Gordon, Mike Greenlay, a 5-3 hockey game. The Solar Bears leading the Houston Aeros. And let's take a look at tonight's second period stats brought to you by your local Texas Jeep and Eagle dealers. Through two periods, 26-20, the Solar Bears out shooting the Houston Aeros. Look at the power play numbers. You know, we talked about the specialty teams a little bit as being a key always, especially down the stretch, and the power play has hurt the Aeros a little bit. 2 of 4, the Solar Bears are on the power play. Greener, what's the update as far as ice times for Yeo and McDonough?
Well, McDonough is, you know, everything's, as you probably would expect, at 12:51 for McDonough, 14:48 for Yeo, so both of them are playing a regular shift, and you'll probably see that in the third period.
And Mike Yeo, very effective once again tonight. Let's take a look at tonight's game summary. It's brought to you by Columbia Healthcare Systems. And in the first period, Hubie McDonough got the first goal of the game at 15:48. And then Scott Arneal at 9:42 from Freer and Townsend. And then Turgeon on the power play at 13:58 from Conroy and Lamb. Second period, here come the Solar Bears. A big three unanswered goals. Fisher, then Neaton, then Fisher again. And it is at that point 4-2 in favor of Orlando. Then Kelly Hurd made it 4-3. And then Craig Fisher got the goal from Dave Barr and Todd Richards. And it is 5-3 in favor of the Solar Bears. When we return, we'll give you the third period. Arrows need two to tie. Hey, look at that young child enjoying the game. Back after this. A 5-3 Solar Bear lead as the Arrows emptying onto the ice. Solar Bears on there as Alan Bester to our left. Wasn't tested too much in that second period. He did let that Kelly Hurd goal in, one that I'm sure he would like to have back. I'll take you back in the early part of the season when Alan Bester really stood on his lips and played very well. And remember that point-blank shot when Scott Arneal had a chance to tie it, and Alan Bester made a great save. But on the other side of things, we talked about Grant Shervin. And Grant Shervin here, this is obviously the highest total he has let up since becoming a Houston Arrow, 5 goals. And it's going to take a good effort from him here to hold his team in there. And I am not saying that he has not had the good effort. I think he's going to have to really step it up and try and give the Arrows a chance to win. Craig Fisher tonight with his 3 goals. And once again, he has another big game against the Houston Arrows. And he is always a handful.
He certainly is. He's up in the scoring leaders, and it's for one reason. He's always around that net, and the puck seems to find him. I know it seems like the puck seems to find him, but actually it's him finding the puck. Goal scorers like that usually have an ability to sniff out those rebounds, and he has found that. He had the breakaway goal, and then the other 2 goals were just because of a good effort in front of the net.
You know what? If you're Craig Fisher, maybe you should dye your hair blonde, call yourself Dennis Rodman, because half your goals are off rebounds.
That's true. He is in there, and he's a tall guy, but he's not big as far as a heavy guy, and so he gets knocked around a bit. But he's also very shifty in front of the net, and he can get free and he can find those areas, and the puck seems to come to him. It's because he's in the right spot at the right time, and that's one of the secrets of goal scoring, I would guess.
So Grant Shervin ready to go as he gets a quick shot of water, and we're about ready. What did you like in your water bottle? Water or Gatorade or whatever?
Water.
Did you?
Yeah, because sometimes you like to splash yourself in the face.
Oh, yeah.
The last thing you want to splash yourself in the face with is a bunch of sticky mess.
That's a good point. Puck is controlled by Alan Bester. He'll hold on. That'd be a good practical joke sometime in practice. Put like some grape juice or something in it.
Well, you know what the guys like to do in practice is the trainer will have all the water bottles lined up along the boards, and one guy will come along and he'll loosen the cap off just enough so that when the other guy turns it over to spray some water, he gets the whole bottle down his shirt.
We did that in elementary school.
Well, now you know what hockey players are like.
Oh, brother. We did it with the salt shaker. All right, face off to the left side of Alan Bester. Maybe the Arrows need to unscrew the cap in front of the Orlando net here and let a couple seep in there. Down 5-3. Eisenhut against Freer in the faceoff circle. Arrows win the draw. Townsend right side trying to move it through Tiley. At the hash marks, Graham Townsend to the line. Hurl butt wide. Shoots right on. Bester safe. Rebound poke behind and they score!
Shot from the point and a good save by Bester, but he can't have the rebound. The puck goes by him, it drops down. Arneal feeds it to Freer, and Freer just jams it in the net.
Ninth of the year for Freer, and the Arrows are within one. I'll tell you what, on this particular play, Allen Bester probably was a little scared and full of all kinds of fear. And there it was into the net. It's 5-4 Orlando.
But a good job by Townsend in the corner to get the puck to Hurlbutt. And you know what? Hurlbutt makes no mistake. He just gets it on net, and that causes a goal.
He'll get an assist along with Arneal. The arrows are within one. Here's Arneal again, or make it Kelly Hurd. Flip one out in front of him, bounce back to the line and out at center. Lanielle turning, give it to Turgeon. He'll rip one in on Allen Bester, and a stick save is made. Richards back to play it, and a whistle.
It's offside as Turgeon dumped it, shot the puck on net while there were, I guess, Arrow players deep in the zone, and when the shot's on net, there's no delayed offside, it's just an automatic whistle.
So a faceoff brought back to center. Lamb, Hurd, and Turgeon with Jenks and Lanielle. Mark Freer, as we said, his ninth of the year, and he has played some terrific hockey here in the new year. Puck is controlled by Lanielle. Up the right side, Jakes. It goes into the Orlando zone, and Pat Neaton will play it. Neaton behind the cage. He will meander and heads up. This is going to be a souvenir. And, oh, I'm looking down at two ladies right in front. We're not paying attention. And one just about took it right off the melon.
A little scared. Maybe they're a little prayer. They're a little prayer.
Don't even try it.
I can't do bad jokes like you. I just can't. All my jokes are good.
Hang with me, babe. Hang with me. It'll come.
That's what I'm scared of. But you know what? That's what happens usually is two people are sitting in the stands and not paying attention. They're just talking back and forth, and they end up eating the puck.
Well,
not wearing the kind of protective equipment that a goaltender is, that's for sure.
If she was leaning a little more to her right, I might have beat her 5-hole. Face off to the right side of Allen Bester. Conroy against McDonough. Bottom of the puck, here's Donnelly. Left point shot, ricocheting off the skates of Turcotte and into the arrow end. Donnelly's got to hustle back. Donnelly beating Turcotte to the puck, trying to get it through there. Hartman knocked it free. Donnelly spun to the pond, but picked up by Yo. Here comes Yo. He'll headman pass out to center for Conroy. He'll hoist it into the Orlando zone. After it, Molik. Drilled by Neaton. McDonough and Conroy again go at it. We'll keep an eye on those two. They had a little discussion earlier, but this time a pretty clean breakup.
Your attention, please.
Well, I think both teams are going to stick to hockey for the remainder of this game. 18 minutes left, and there's lots of time for anything to happen. The Arrows have closed the gap by one. It's 5-4 for Orlando, and that's one of the big things I see a big change in, and that is the Arrows are relentless, a lot like the team we saw last year. Orlando, of course, is relentless as well, as the Arrows took the lead for a while there, but they came back with a few unanswered goals. But a good job by Dave Tippett getting his team back into this one.
Face off to the left side of Mark Buffet, and the Solar Bears win the draw. Up the left side, it is Todd Richards. He will scamper to center. Richards through the neutral zone. He will hammer it into the arrow end. Sail to the fireside. Jake's trying to clear, cannot. Now Jakes will try it again as he heads behind the net. Tossed it over to Lanielle. Bumped it ahead for Yo. And the arrows are out at center. Yo hit by Buffet. Here is Maurice trying to feather one ahead. It was a bit too hard for Conroy. And across the line, Buffet with Frederick. Buffet cutting in. Shoots and went right down to Sherman. He will cover up and hold on. Those are sometimes the toughest shots when A, you're partially screened, and B, it wasn't nearly as hard as maybe he thought it was going to come, but Sherman played it well. 2 minutes gone in the third and a 5-4 Solar Bear lead.
Well, Buffet just cuts across the slot. He waits and waits and finally does get a shot. It kind of deflects off the heel of Lanielle's stick a little bit, and then Sherman already down, and that's a very prone position for a goaltender is when you're seated, because it's tough to get up and it's tough to have any mobility. It teaches the young goaltenders to keep their gloves forward, and if you fall down, to fall forward onto your knees, and it allows you to get up quicker. But Sherman going down, and he still made the save, and he was able to cover up.
Face off left side of Grant Sherman, and the puck is played by Conroy and shot out at center. Solar Bears trying to turn it ahead, circa, roll it over to Joyce, and now McDonough, left side, fired it into the Houston arrow end. Back to play at O'Connor as he's watched by Turcotte. It's shot out at center. And then Maurice had to regroup in his own end, and that means the Solar Bears have it now. Turcotte trying to move it in. Turcotte to Joyce, one-time shot, deflected away by Donnelly. Now into the corner, Donnelly muscled in there by Turcotte, fired away. It'll go to the boards for Mike Maurice. He'll chip it to the line and out at center ice. LeBlanc trying to fire it back in. It came to center, and the arrows can't control. McDonough fakes the shot, drew Donnelly down, passed over to LeBlanc, but the arrows have it.
Maurice with Freer. Maurice across the line with Mark Freer. Here's Maurice cutting in. Maurice looks in front. Freer trying to work a moving screen as Arneal's shot. Oh, went off the skates of Joyce and just wide of the net. Joyce will shoot it the length of the ice, and it will be icing as Hurlbutt will go back, and he will play it, and we will take timeout. 3 minutes gone in the third period. It's the Solar Bears 5, the Arrows 4 back after this, but first, sail away on Southwest Airlines. Welcome back to the Summit, everybody. We're in the third, and the Solar Bears lead at 5-4. Alan Bester didn't get much help on the fourth goal he let in, and the Arrows are within one, sniffing blood. Face off to the left of Alan Bester. Freer with Arneal and Townsend. Sticks down, drop of the puck. It's kicked back to the line for Gord Krupke. He will tee it up, rip the shot right on. Bester the save. And it'll go to the far side. Krupke pinching, trying to steer it down for Graham Townsend. He spun off the puck. Richards trying to clear it. Krupke held nicely at the hash marks right side. Krupke fights for it. Here's Gord Krupke. Centered the shot. Stop, rebound. Went just wide by Freer. He had two marvelous pokes at it, but Bester may have gotten the best of Freer on that particular exchange. Now the puck back in the Arrow end. Duncanson turning in the corner. Went to the fireside bar, and Krupke go hard into the corner. Eisenhut trying to roll it down. They go at it some more as it's pushed in there. Krupke trying to work it free. Duncanson's got it for Orlando. Puck resting far side. Here is Barr trying to move it down. Controlled by Eisenhut. Eisenhut centered Richards. It went off skates. Duncanson turning, popped away. Can the Arrows clear it? Yes, they will. Back is Brad Tiley. He'll fire it into the Arrow end. Sherman back to play it, and Krupke will play. Krupke rolled it ahead for Lamb. Lamb trying to move it through Fisher. And the Solar Bears reject that rush. Frederick trying to advance, and Lanyell will go back. Mark Lanyell ripped it along the boards for Lamb. He'll move to center and fire it ahead. It is Kelly Hurd who's got a goal in this hockey game. Couldn't get it around Joyce. Back to play it, Fisher. Lob the puck ahead. It's out at center. Lanyell is there. He will hoist that high in the air and heads up. That is going to be a souvenir.
So the Arrows playing good hockey in every area of the ice. A good look of Gord Krupke down low here. And Gord Krupke makes a good decision. He stays down. You know, some guys are indecisive and they kind of get caught halfway. He doesn't. It feeds the puck out front. Freer gets a couple whacks at it. A good play by Krupke to stay with his guns and stay with the pinch, stay down low. He picks up the puck and he makes a good feed out front. Freer gets a couple good shots. Bester made a couple good saves, and the score remains 5-4 Orlando.
Here's Beauvais across the line, and a penalty coming up to the Houston Arrows. Well, the Arrows are going to be down a man, and this time you really have to caution this, because the last two power plays that Orlando has had, Greener, have hit Pater. Now Jenks goes into the box.
They are 2-for-4 on the night. This is their fifth, and Beauvais showing some of that acceleration, and a big bear hug by Jenks. He won't get away with it as Hansen makes the call. He drags down Beauvais, and the Orlando Solar Bears will go on the power play.
You know, you talk about a team coming together. Here's where I think it really pays off. Here's Jakes that takes a penalty for holding. He's in the box. Now he needs his teammates to come up big for him and kill this off. And not only for, of course, him, but for the entire hockey club. Now the puck is controlled by Conroy. Conroy turns it out at center ice for Mark Lamb. And down the ice it'll go. Back to play it is Todd Richards as he's sized up by Al Conroy. Picked up by Barr. Here comes Fisher out at center. Fisher with Beauvais across the line. Fisher, who's got three goals tonight, turned it around behind the net, but it's picked up by Lamb. He will turn and rip it all the way down the ice. 14:48 to go in the third, a 5-4 hockey game. Orlando leads it. They're on the power play for a minute 22. Todd Richards at center. Shoots it into the Arrow zone. Sherman will slow it. Picked up by Hurlbutt. Ripped to the line. Not out. Second effort. Picked up by Yo. He'll move it 2-on-2 with Freer. Yo got by Kylie. It's 2-on-1. Short-handed. Use it on goal. Wait. Shoot. Stop. Rebound. Bester came up big there. And Beauvais will play right side and get it out at center. Oh, Mike Yo all of a sudden found a 2-on-1 but couldn't get it in the net.
Cirka with 52 on the power play. Got it ahead for Alfie Turcott. Turcott at center to Neaton. And it's into Arrow territory. Back to the corner. McDonough sends it behind, looking Turcott. Get it LeBlanc to the line. LeBlanc, right circle. Shoots at ricocheted wide. And that'll carry him all the way back to center ice. Half a minute remaining in the power play. And the Solar Bears will go to gather it in. Cirka, give it to McDonough. And he'll gently roll it out at center. It goes into the Arrow end for Turcott, but Arneal is there. Couldn't advance it, though. Turcott left side, moves in, looking for McDonough. That's knocked away. It came back to the line for Neaton with 10 on the power play. Neaton to the left side. Turcott slides it in. McDonough the shot, and that went wide of the net. Well, I'll tell you, McDonough cuts in. Shoot, stopped by Sherman. Loose in front, the shot. That's hooked just wide. Holy cow. And the puck is finally cleared. The Arrows were able to kill off the penalty. And it's back into the Arrow end. Connolly will turn it. Now the Arrows can go to work on the one-goal deficit. Here's the pass to Maurice in across the line. But the Solar Bears are there. They will clear it out at neutral. Lanyell turns, gets it back into his end. Lanyell turning, get it back for Jakes. Back for Lanyell. They're going back and forth. And Lanyell will turn and get it out at center for Lamb. Cross the ice for Turgeon. Sylvain Turgeon trying to move in. Pass came over. Maurice couldn't pull the trigger. Now to the corner, Richards played it behind the cage. On the near side, Eisenhut. It's pumped out at center. 12:40 to go in the third. A 5-4 Solar Bear lead. Here comes Kelly Hurt across the line. Give it Turgeon. Shoots Besker. The stick save. He will cover up and he will hold on. 12:32 to go in the third. It's the Solar Bears 5. The Arrows 4. It best be that you come back.
Welcome back, and Mike Yeo makes a good effort on a shorthanded play, makes a good move around Hartman, gets in on a two-on-one. He'll take it himself as he goes in and tries to beat Bester five-hole. He misses his own rebound, but a great opportunity for Mike Yeo breaking down the wing, making some great moves. He didn't have the pass, so he went in for the shot and couldn't make it count. It still remains 5-4.
And a face-off to the right side of Bester. Top of the puck, Solar Bears cleared, not out, held in Lanyell, behind the net, Lamb, it took a hop, picked up by Buffet, he'll clear to the near side, it's to the line, Lanyell, rolled it behind the cage, they fight for the loose puck. In behind now, Lamb wanted to get there, but Cirka cleared, and it's out at center ice. After it, Lanyell back to his own blue line, feathered a pass out at center for Jakes, Jakes pass, tipped away. 8 minutes gone in the third and a 5-4 hockey game. Puck is back and the Solar Bears have got it. Besker for Tiley. He will turn along the near side for Barb. Bumped away and the Solar Bears are out at center. Buffet, he'll move it up the left side. Buffet across the line. He's got the chance in front. Barb shooting. Oh, great save by Sherman. And the puck is played away. Sherman got a blocker on that. It's controlled by Tiley. Headman pass. Buffet goes into the Arrow end. We're down to 11:40 to go in the third and a 5-4 hockey game. Conroy, his pass into the Orlando zone. It's back to neutral and Hurlbutt is at his own blue line for Krupke. Trying to move it ahead. Neaton was scraped off by Maurice and the Solar Bears will push it ahead. Overskinned by Hurlbutt. He had to go back to get it. Loose puck gathered in by Orlando. Here's the chance. Eisenhut scraped away by Yeo. And it's gathered in and pushed away. Out at center, Hartman rolled it into Houston Arrow territory. Krupke trying to move it ahead, but Hurlbutt is there. Great action as the Arrows need one. They're down 5-4. Duncanson across the line, shoots, and Sherman a left pad save. Now the puck sails in behind the net. It's Neil Eisenhut for Orlando, waiting. Came out in front, stuck it right in, and Sherman had to make a very alert left pad save. He will cover up and hold on. 10:49 to go in the third, and the Solar Bears lead it 5-4.
The Arrows picked up their men, but Eisenhut steps out from behind the net. Krupke has to go with that guy. Eisenhut says, hey, I have a lane, I'm gonna take it. As looks like Hurlbutt comes across the crease to take his man as they switch. Krupke's gotta stay with Duncanson. Hurlbutt comes across, and I even think it did hit Hurlbutt, but very alert. Sherman covers up as after hits its pad. It remains 5-4 Solar Bears.
Face off to the left side of Grant Sherman. Freer against Turcott. Arrows need a tally here. Donnelly in behind the net. He'll push one ahead. It's out at center ice. Richard scooped it ahead into the Houston arrow end, and Donnelly is there to play it. Forecheck by Turcotte, but we've got a whistle and a late call here on the offsides. 10:39 to go.
Lots of time left for the Houston Arrows. Donnelly having a very good game, playing strongly in his own zone, covering up very well, blocking shots like a madman.
He was pretty well maligned in the first half of the season, but he was also the first to admit that he wasn't playing a Gord Donnelly type of hockey in that first half, but he has really picked up his play in his last six or seven hockey games. Puck goes into the Orlando zone. Richards flipped it off the glass, and it's all the way back into the arrow end. Miles O'Connor will play it as he's pursued by McDonough. Arrows trying to break it out of their end. O'Connor moves it out to Arneal at center ice. Trying to feather one ahead for Townsend, but the Solar Bears reject that, and up the center they come. It is Turcotte, dropped it back for Neaton. His shot goes wide. It took a square hop off the end wall, and Shervin will hold on with 10:06 to go in the third, and the Arrows down 5-4.
It's at this point that the Arrows are going to need a big play, try and get themselves in the game. Of course, 10 minutes is a lot of time. Dave Tippett sending out the right guys at the right time. Right now, he's coming out with Conroy, Maurice, and Yo. Going to try and get them down deep in the zone, do some hitting, and maybe cause some turnovers.
A terrific crowd on hand tonight. 14,000 plus on hand to see the Arrows and the Solar Bears, and all 14,000 plus being treated to an outstanding hockey game once again. Al Conroy ready to take the faceoff against Mark Buffet to the right side of Shervin. Off the draw, it's controlled. Yo moves it out at center ice. Now the Solar Bears push it in. Yo has to go in after it. He'll fire it off the boards and out at center ice. Brad Tiley. He'll stream one into the arrow end, and it's knocked down by Jakes. Jakes trying to move it up ice. Rolled one ahead for Yo, and it's back at neutral ice. Tiley is there. Tiley fired it into the Houston arrow end, and out of the net it's Grant Shervin. He'll leave it for Lanyell. Lanyell up the far boards, trying to get it out of the zone. Now the Solar Bears have gone back to their bread and butter line. They've got Fisher, Barr, and Buffet out there. Here is Yo across the line, trying to get it through Tiley. Conroy trying to move it ahead. Buffet knocked it down into the corner. The Arrows trying to move it. Yo was jammed off the puck by Barr. Yo got right back up. And now Buffet takes over. And he'll gently roll it out at center ice. Out of the net, it's Grant Shervin. Swings one at center. Maurice overskated, but the Arrows still have it. Kupke ripped one into the zone, blocked by Todd Richards, and turned ahead. And Kupke trying to get back to work it away. And a nice play by Gord Kupke to get over there. And he will thwart that rush. And if offside's call, let's take timeout. 9:01 to go in the third period. It's the Solar Bears 5, the Arrows 4. More IHL action when we return. It's 5-4 in favor of the Orlando Solar Bears. The Arrows on fire in 96. And you know what? Speaking of on fire, it's a salute to the brave men and women of the Houston Fire Department. Join us Sunday, February 4th at the Summit. The Houston Fire Department calendar guys will be on hand to battle it out in a tug of war on the ice. Ladies, get your tickets now. You don't want to miss this at Sunday, February 4th at 4 p.m. Your wife Amy called me, wanted a whole block of tickets.
Lots of friends. Of course, she won't be attending.
No. She's got her firefighter at home, right? You gonna? Oh, never mind. I'm leaving it alone, or I'll never be allowed over at the Greenlay House. Puck is controlled by the Arrows in the Solar Bear zone. Lamb sends, Turnshaw shoots. Oh, great save by Bester. Wow, nearly played some string music there, but there was Bester with a glove save to remove that from the jaws of the twine.
Well, Turnshaw doesn't get as much as he wanted on this one. He has to kick it to his forehand first. If he would have gotten that one like the one timer he had in the first period, that thing might have been in the net. But having to kick it to his forehand, he couldn't get as much mustard as the Orlando defenseman was coming up on him. But he still got away. A half decent shot. Bester had to be sharp.
8:40 to go in regulation. Orlando 5, Houston 4. Lamb, Turgeon, Hurd, Krupke, and Hurlbut. Eisenhut to take the draw against Mark Lamb. In the circle to the right side of Alan Bester. Eisenhut, he's ready. Lamb is two. Eisenhut wins the draw, but Lamb gathered it in. Then pushed off the puck by Cirka. Duncanson turning in his own end. He'll shoot the center ice for Hartman. Dumped the puck in. Hartman goes into the corner, sized up by Hurlbut. Hurlbut trying to work Hartman into the corner. They continue to battle it out, skate to skate. Turgeon trying to dig it out.
It went behind the net. Eisenhut. He's hit by Krupke in the end wall. Krupke trying to move it ahead. It takes a bump in front. The shot went wide. Here's a chance for Orlando to the line. Richards takes the shot. Richards jammed it down. We're down to 8 minutes. And it is 5-4 Orlando. Lamb to center ice. Kershaw across the line. He's bumped and dumped by Serka. Good play there. Crowd wants a penalty, but no.
He got his glove up in his face. I think that's what the crowd saw.
Here comes Serka. And then Kershaw, ooh, getting the stick dug in there a little bit. And the puck is back into the arrow end. Jakes. He'll move it up ice. Jakes to the neutral zone for Scott Arneal. Dumped it into the Orlando end. Trace was back. Caromed it off the glass. It's out at center. Lanyell back to play it at his own blue line. Pursued by John LeBlanc. Pass gingerly up for Jakes, and here come the arrows. Slipchenko with Freer and Arneal. Slivy over to Freer, pulls up right side, centered Arneal, the back door, couldn't get the one-timer in there. It went to the near corner, picked up by Turcotte. Wrapped up by Arneal, LeBlanc cleared it out at center, and Jakes is there. 7:10 to go. 5-4 Orlando. Here's Mark Freer, across the line. Freer makes the move.
Give him a rope. He hauled down Mark Freer, and I'm surprised after he hauled him down, he didn't throw him down and tie his legs up.
It is a penalty. I'm just kind of curious how much Freer put into that, though.
Well, I mean, you'll watch it right here if you're enjoying the game on Prime. He gets him hooked up, and then he spins him around. He's got one leg in the air already.
Yeah, all right.
You know, you only have so much balance on those blades, and with that, he twists him around, and Freer had nowhere else to go but in the air. Freer, and down he went, regardless of which way you look at it.
Mark Freer is not a diver. I just thought, at first look, it looked like he kind of made it look good, but after a look at that replay, no, he got spun out.
And Neaton, certainly no stranger to the clutch and grab game tonight on the power play. The Arrows are 1-for-3 with 5 shots. They need to get the puck up front there and try and jam one in. Turgeon and Yo on the wing, and Conroy at center, O'Connor and Lamb on the points.
Well, if I'm one of the 14,000 here, I want to make some noise and get this Arrow hockey team fired up on the power play. Here's O'Connor, winding, shooting, deflected away. Oh, it went up on Bester. Miles O'Connor grabbed his sand wedge and tried to put a little bite on that puck so that it would go behind Bester. And Bester had to reach up and grab it and hold on.
Well, I think it deflected off an Orlando stick, as getting into the play was Alfie Turcotte. Gets his stick down there, and Bester decides to hang on because if that puck bounces behind the net like it was going to, it could have caused some trouble down deep. He'd rather take the faceoff.
Conroy, Yo, and Turgeon with O'Connor and Lamb. Conroy tossed out of the circle, so now it's Mark Lamb that'll take the draw. Lamb against Dave Barr. Lamb wins the draw to Conroy. Quickly spins it down behind the net. Richards is there. Can he clear it? O'Connor held. O'Connor at the hash marks right side for Turgeon. Back Conroy. He's bumped by Buffet. Here's Lamb now. Lamb on his knees, trying to work it ahead. Turgeon to the line. Here's the shot right on. It was blocked, though. It never made it to Bester. Picked up by Buffet and shot down the ice.
Very aggressive power play right now. You can see by the arrows, they're working it hard along the boards. They won that battle, but they didn't win the war as the puck didn't get through.
O'Connor, rink wide for Al Conroy. Conroy give it to Turgeon, too far, so he's cleared it, and it's back down at center. It hit the linesman. And what's the call?
I think it hit the padding on the inside of the penalty box and came right back out, and therefore they call it that it had left the rink.
Yeah.
And then they're going to whistle it down. The Arrows will change up on the play.
6:13 to go in the third. Orlando with a 5-4 lead, 1:11 left in the minor to Neaton. And Dave Tippett, he's pacing just a little bit more on the bench and hoping someone like Lanyell or anyone out there. Lanyell's out there with Hurlbutt, Freer, Townsend, and Arneal. What a hockey game Mark Freer's had tonight.
He certainly has. So is Arneal. Townsend getting in there and causing some trouble as well. But Arneal and Freer doing a great job together, each assisting on each other's goals tonight. And hopefully assisting on each other's goals right now. As you mentioned, they have a minute 11 to work on Neaton's penalty here.
Freer against McDonough.
Sticks down, dropping the puck, and McDonough trying to move it ahead. It was picked up by Freer, but popped away by Cirka. Lanyell crossed the ice for Arneil. He'll dump the puck in. Back to play at Richards. Richards taken into the boards by Freer. Freer fighting for it. Cirka knocked it away. Townsend and McDonough go hard after it. And then McDonough uses his hand and cleared it ahead. That's legal. And here's Joe Frederick shorthanded. Trying to move it through Lanyell. Can't get it through him. They continue to grapple for it. And the Arrows come away. They're down to 43 on the power play. Lanyell to the near side, Arneil, who takes a hip check from Todd Richards. It goes to the far side, and Freer again fighting for it with Jeff Cirka. Cirka kicked it free in the corner. Freer trying to knock it ahead. Here's Graham Townsend, base of the right circle. Townsend wrapped up by McDonough. The Solar Bears turn, clear it the length of the ice. 20 seconds to go in the power play. 5:21 to go in the third. It's a 5-4 Solar Bear lead. Pass knocked away, and the Solar Bears clear it. Hurlbutt trying to move it ahead, and then Townsend took a stick in the face inadvertent from Duncanson, and he is down, but I'm sure he'll get back up. But it was an inadvertent. They were fighting for the puck as he was down on the ice. I don't think you can call a penalty like that when you're down on the ice and catch an inadvertent stick like that.
No, because the stick wasn't above the the height of the crossbar. They say above the shoulders, but I think the gauge they use is 6 feet high in the crossbar. But he goes into the boards and or goes into Duncanson, and he goes down eventually, and then the stick comes up, catches him in the face.
Maybe, I don't know. I mean, at this point,
actually, you know, it was Hurlbutt's stick that hit him. I don't think you're right. Give him a penalty for that.
No.
8 seconds remaining on the Arrow power play. The Arrows hadn't been able to really. They worked really hard along the boards and got one or two chances, but weren't able to really control down in the zone. Slivchenko out there right now to try and make something happen.
Face off between Conroy and Eisenhut. Sticks down, drop of the puck. Eisenhut wins the draw. It's back out at center. And the Solar Bears shoot it down. That'll do it for the Houston Arrow power play.
The line of penalty time has expired.
Here is Al Conroy. In his own end, Conroy. A pass at center, too far for Slivchenko. If Slivchenko can get there, it'll negate the icing. He cannot. Joyce is there, and whistle stops play. 4:52 to go in the third period. It's the Solar Bears 5, the Arrows 4, and we're back after this. Welcome back to the Summit, everybody. Along with Mike Greenlay, I'm Adam Gordon. A 5-4 Solar Bear lead. A little boring hockey game, huh?
Yeah.
What a great game.
Tell you what, the Arrows have really put some great pressure down in the zone of the Orlando Solar Bears, but they just can't get the puck by Bester right now. They brought it within one. They just need that extra one to tie this game up.
Face off left side of Grant Shervin. Drop of the puck, and the Arrows win the draw. It's Gord Donnelly meandering in behind the cage, and then it's flushed out to the near side for Miles O'Connor. Pass tipped away. Conroy spun and fell, and here comes Hartman. Hartman was drilled by Gord Donnelly. Puck in behind the net, and the Arrows get it out of there. Donnelly's got it through Eisenhut. It's bounced to the near side for Yo, and he'll romp to center ice. Yo through the neutral zone. Mike Yo hits the line. Yo trying to move in around Joyce. Yo has Conroy in front. The shot. Wow! Great save. Rebound. Shoots. Bester save. Rebound. Back to the line. Donnelly. He tees it up. Shoots deflected. Oh, what a great chance. Fanned on by Maurice. Oh, the Arrows had some great chances. Hit shot the length of the ice. And icing is the call as O'Connor is there. 4:09 to go in the third. And the Arrows nearly labeled one behind Alan Bester, but it's still 5-4.
You know, we talked about Mike Yo and the way that he's been playing. He takes his pucking all alone. He's got someone in front, and he tries to feed it there. Gets a whack at it. Conroy with a good chance and a great save by Bester. The puck will come back to the point, and a good shot by Donnelly. And Bester comes up with another save. You see the rebound coming back out, and then they whack away at it in front. I think Maurice eventually gets a chance in front, and he fans on the shot. The puck's cleared the length of the ice, but the Arrows showing that they are never going to say die here with 4:09 left. That's plenty of time with the way the Arrows are playing.
Face off left side of Alan Bester. Lamb, Hurd, Turgeon with Lanyell and Jakes. Buffet, Barr, and McDonough now. So they've taken Fisher off that line and put McDonough. So Kurt Frazier, the head coach of the Solar Bears, doing some line juggling. Solar Bears win the draw, and it is controlled by Pat Neaton. Moves it out at center, just missing Buffet. And Shervin came out, flipped it away into the corner for Steve Jakes. Jakes get it for Sylvain Turgeon. Turgeon, center ice pass, picked up by Kelly Hurd across the line, trying to move around Neaton. Kelly Hurd lost an edge, crashed and burned. Here's a Jakes in front, as it was misplayed, but the Arrows couldn't get it on goal. Now back at center, it is Jakes. Hands it to Lanyell, over to Jakes. His pass knocked away, and Beauvais across the line. Now Fisher with Barr. Here's Barr. Down low, it's spot in. Beauvais, the shot, they score! It was Mark Beauvais, and the Solar Bears take a 6-4 lead.
The Solar Bears get a goal late in the game. The Arrows putting on great pressure, just can't find the mark. Then Beauvais gets the puck all alone, walks in front and puts it upstairs. Barr fakes a shot, draws a couple of defensemen towards him, and Beauvais has a lot of room to walk in and slide it in low. Shervin falling down, coming down, trying to make that stack pad save, and he misses on the poke check as Beauvais slides it underneath his arm. Beauvais gives his team a 6-4 lead. Now they're starting to throw on the ice the seat cushions that were given to them, and there's going to be a lot of them come. And you know what? Someone, Todd Schrock, media relations director, predicted this was going to happen, and it's happening now. This is going to take a long time to clean up. There are dozens and dozens of seat cushions that they were giving out before the game are ended up on the ice.
You know what? If I were a doctor, I'd make a lot of money, because I think all these people need brain surgery.
Well, you know, I'll tell you a story. I guess it's kind of funny now, but at the time it wasn't. They handed out pucks one game, and they handed them out before the game in Atlanta. And what happened is it went all the way to a shootout. And in the shootout, some kid threw the puck on the ice as one of the opposing team's players was coming down on goal. And he missed the shot. The puck that was thrown on the ice was nowhere near the net, but it's still, the referee judged that, hey, this is your home building. You threw the puck on the ice when the opposing team was taking a shot. So he got another shot. He scored on that shot. That eventually was the game winner. And that kid snuck out of the building pretty quietly afterwards. He didn't sneak out, but he was quick to leave after the police had talked to him, that's for sure.
Well, look at the bright side. They told me I couldn't have any seat cushions because they didn't have enough. I think I'll get some now.
Yeah, those will look good on your patio. No more griddle marks on your chairs.
Well, while we've got a moment here, let's remind everybody our next Prime Sports telecast. It's Wednesday, the 24th of January, when the Arrows take on the Atlanta Knights. It's Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, right here at the Summit. You can catch all the action right here on Prime Sports and 950 KPRC Radio. 3:33 to go in the third. Solar Bears 6, Arrows 4. And while we also have a second, I want to remind all our viewers as well as our listeners on KPRC to join us on radio following this telecast for the Arrows post-game highlight show. We will take your calls and answer your questions. I'm sure there'll be some thoughts on tonight's hockey game, and we'd like to hear from you tonight. So stay tuned to 950 KPRC following tonight's hockey game. 6-4 Orlando, and the Arrows are down by 2 once again. Here's Todd Richards back in his own end. Pass at center ice for McDonough, and it goes into the arrow end. Out of the net, Grant Shervin. Flinged it near side, Arneal. He's scraped by McDonough. Arneal to McDonough. Battling out along the boards, and Arneal will come away with the puck. Out at center for Slivchenko. Slivchenko makes a great move, cuts in on goal, shoots, best for save, that went wide. Lanyell pinching, make it clear rather than trying to center that. And it's tipped away by McDonough. Picked up again by Slivchenko. Back to the line, Hurlbutt. Line shoots, deflected away. Picked up Slivchenko. Slivchenko banks to the right circle, trying to move it in, but it was knocked away. Here is Miles O'Connor. Give it to Freer. Tossed in behind the net, and Bester will cover up with 2:49 remaining. 6-4 Orlando.
Well, the Arrows are going to, as they are doing right now, putting pressure on, but they're going to have to get one real quick here in order to give themselves an opportunity at jamming one in late.
The Arrows, busy weekend. They're in Vegas tomorrow. It's a radio-only game on KPRC. And then Sunday night from the Delta Center, it's another special edition of Saturday Night on Ice on UPN 20. The Arrows and the defending Turner Cup champion Utah Grizzlies. Sunday night at 7 on UPN 20 and KPRC Radio.
I can't wait to see that Delta Center. I've never been there. I heard the seating not really conducive for the fans, but it's a great building, though.
It is a beautiful, beautiful building. You will enjoy it when you see it.
Will you be there with me?
I think so.
Cool. All right. My trip is set now. Locked to the near side. It's picked up by the Aero Slam. Tossed it down. Conroy. It came out in front. And it's that is clear. Gee, that thing was a little further up. We'd have a souvenir.
I've seen enough pucks.
Well, I was going to say, you probably step in front of me, go through five hole, and hit me anyway on the end.
Oh, just let me have it. Hey, I might save your life someday up here. You never know.
I hope so.
Or I might let it in on
purpose.
Yeah,
I know. The old left-hand glove save punched me in the face.
fake him with the save and catch him with the right.
All right. Face off to the right side of Alan Bester. Conroy against Eisenhut. Sticks down, drop of the puck, picked up by Circa, and cleared out at center. And back is Miles O'Connor. Arrows need two. It's not out of the realm, but the odds, well, they can take it to Vegas tomorrow. Lamb popped it into the Orlando zone. Back is Circa. Jammed it near side, Frederick. Worked ahead by the Solar Bears. It's down the ice. Pearlbutt will go back to play it. Hartman sizes him up. And Lamb will control. Mark Lamb through the neutral zone, popped it in. Joyce goes back, and he will fling it off the boards. It's out at neutral ice. We'll keep an eye on Shervin with 2 minutes remaining. Conroy trying to rip it in. There's Richards to turn it around, and he will turn and just fire it into the arrow end. Yo, back to play it. Trying to move it in behind the net. Yo, watched by Duncanson. Sochenko trying to clear. It hits skates. Turcotte down the left side. Popped away by Steve Jakes. And here comes Slipchenko with some room to wheel. Slipchenko right side. Trying to move it through Pat Pete. Cannot do it. Bester will cover up and take no chances. And now, with 1:35 remaining, I think Dave Tippett might be pulling Grant Shervin with the faceoff to Bester's left. That is just a speculation.
Well, I'm sure he's thinking about it. I don't know if he wants to do it with this much time, but you do need two goals, so it's definitely within the, as you say, the realm of possibilities. He is calling a timeout, so with the play down deep in the zone, he might very well do that.
So Mark Freer goes over to the referee, Scott Hansen, and says timeout. And let's reset the game for you. We've got 1:35 remaining in the third. Solar Bears lead at 6-4 on a Mark Beaufait goal. And Dave Tippett now will call his troops together here. And I'm thinking back in the preseason, and I'm trying to remember, I don't remember if you, were you in Rochester, Minnesota with us during the preseason? I don't remember. Anyway, it was.
Yes, it was.
Yeah, because we were sitting there, and if you remember, the Arrows were
sitting up there freezing watching the game.
It was a tie hockey game, or it was a 5-4 game, something like that. Minnesota was leading in a preseason game in Rochester. Tippett calls his troops together, diagrams a play, and within 19 seconds, Slivchenko ties the game, and the Arrows win it in a shootout. So Dave Tippett may be hoping to reach into his bag of tricks once again, but the difference here is one goal is not going to really help. It'll get you within one, but then you got to go back and do it again.
Well, then it's Hail Mary time. I mean, it gives the possibility for something like that to happen, where when you're within one goal, you can dump something towards the net and hope something happens. But Shervin is coming off, as you predicted, and for the extra attacker, and they'll try and pop one home here and give themselves a chance. We've seen plenty of goals scored against the Arrows late in the game. Maybe it's time for them to turn the tables like they have in this 96th season.
Freer, Arneal, Turgeon, Townsend, Conroy, and Lamb. Empty net, and the puck is rolling toward it, and look at this. Look at this. Do you believe that? A goal, and that'll make it 7-4. The Arrows never got a chance, but you know what? We harp on this all the time about how important it is to win a faceoff.
Well, certainly, especially in the situation where your net is empty. You know, a lot of coaches will won't suggest to players to try and hit the net from way down in that end, because it's not necessarily a sure thing, and you could give yourself a faceoff down in your zone again. But this puck was just dumped out, and it just rolled and rolled and rolled as Richards just dumps it out of the zone. And it's a good shot as it starts rolling, and it'll kind of curve back in. It would have gone through the crease anyways, but it does roll into the net.
Was that an in-turn or an out-turn? The sweepers kind of swept that in.
Hurry.
Here is Turcotte. He'll move it ahead to McDonough. It's 7-4 Orlando. And of course, Sherwin not credited with the seventh goal. He was not on the ice for the goal against. Puck is shot out at center. Knocked through the neutral zone, and Laniel is there with 1:03 to go. So Dave Tippett will pick up his first loss as a head coach in 96. And the Arrows will go back to the drawing board tomorrow against the Las Vegas Thunder in Vegas. Jakes to Townsend at center, across the line. Esther comes out but won't play it. Circa is there. And it's jammed the length of the ice. 37 seconds to go. Jakes will play it, and icing is the call, and they'll bring the faceoff back into the Orlando zone. And it's time for our Texaco star of the game. It's brought to you by Texaco, and with three goals tonight, Craig Fisher is our Texaco star of the game. It is the second hat trick of the season for Craig Fisher. And we have a look at one of his goals.
Well, Richards takes the shot, and the rebound comes out. Dave Barr gets a good shot at it, too, but Sherwin makes a save, and Fisher's right in there for the third shot. He makes no doubt about it. He pops it upstairs, and he's our Texaco star of the game.
Face off to the left side of Alan Bester. Lamb with Maurice and Turgeon. Defensively, Krupke and Donnelly. Puck is controlled by Joyce. Work to the near side, to the line. Donnelly held it in. Trying to work it into the corner. Now Turgeon trying to move it ahead. Joyce kicking it free. In there fighting for it was Mike Maurice. Turgeon in there scraping some more with Joyce. Turgeon came in with a shot. Bester stopped it. Another puck. Jam wide. Rebound. Score. Lamb may have gotten a piece of it. But regardless, Arrows are back within two. But there's 14 seconds remaining. It would take a complete miracle, but I've seen three goals scored in 7 seconds, or in 14 seconds.
Wow, I've never seen that, but it would be good at this point. Lamb does get the goal as he's surrounded by two Orlando players, and he tips it in. Good work by Turgeon. So Mark Lamb will get credit for that goal. It's his sixth of the season.
Off the faceoff, it's picked up by Gord Krupke. And he will turn and rip the puck in, and that's the save, and that will be the hockey game. Neaton jammed it off the wall, and the Arrows' three-game winning streak is done. Lamb, and he moved it out in front. Bester played it, and there's the buzzer ending the hockey game. So three in a row is the new mark for the Houston Arrows as it snapped tonight with a 7-5 loss. Alan Bester being congratulated as Bester picks up win number 17 on the year, while Grant Sherwin will pick up his first loss. Kurt Fraser, the head coach of the Orlando Solar Bears, has to be pleased that his hockey team snapped their three-game winless streak.
Well, you know that they were going to come into this building kind of steaming. They were 0-2-1 in their last three. You knew that they'd come in hard trying to break that streak, and they did, as they beat the Arrows 7-5.
All right, 7-5 the final, and we will wrap things up when we return. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Summit. It's a final. The Solar Bears have snapped the Arrows' three-game winning streak, and they've snapped their three-game winless streak with a 7-5 win. And let's take a look at tonight's Gatorade play of the game. And, you know, the Arrows were down within one, but a tough, tough break here, Greener.
Well, it was a good play by Barr. He drew two players to him, two defensemen, and it allowed Beaufait to go in. And with Beaufait walking in like that, Sherwin went for the poke check, missed it, and he slid it underneath him.
So it was 6-4 at that point, and then a goal late on the empty net by Todd Richards made it 7-4. The Arrows' Mark Lamb added a goal there, and it was 7-5, and that is the final. With that, let's take a look at tonight's final stats, and they're brought to you by your local Texas Dodge dealers. Final shots, 36-33 in favor of the Houston Arrows, and I think the power play for Orlando really was effective tonight, going 2 of 5. That kind of hurt the Arrows. The Arrows went 1 of 4 on the power play tonight.
The Arrows with 28 faceoffs won, 24 faceoffs won by the Solar Bears. I want to comment on that in a second, Greener. 6 penalties for 12 minutes for the Solar Bears, 7 penalties for 14 minutes for the Houston Arrows. I'm kind of thinking back at some key points in that third period, and it seemed like the Solar Bears kind of owned the faceoff circle at the key points in that third period.
Well, we've talked about how important that is, and when you're winning the faceoffs in key situations, you're gaining control of the puck, and that gives you possession. Possession is
nine-tenths of the law.
And it's a big part of hockey.
And the other thing quickly, Greener, was Grant Sherwin wasn't really making the saves that we've seen in the first 5 games. He didn't play that poorly, just wasn't making the same kind of saves.
Yeah, a couple times he made two saves, 3 saves, and then they scored on him, but there were a couple other situations where normally he would have stopped those from what we've seen.
All right, thanks very much, Greener.
Thank you.
All right, the Arrows, next game will be tomorrow night when the Arrows take on the Las Vegas Thunder. That game could be heard on KPRC Radio. And the next telecast on Prime Sports will be the Arrows and the Atlanta Knights, Wednesday night from the Summit right here at 7 o'clock. Once again, tonight's final score, the Orlando Solar Bears 7, the Houston Arrows 5. For Mike Greenlay, this is Adam Gordon saying so long from the Summit.